the studio tonight. Can I tell you, I am so blessed around 2, 4, 5. Woo! 5 Jamaican brothers. Can I tell you? Mm-hmm. So I'm a lovely rose. Ooh, blooming among all the thorns tonight. I feel great and I feel blessed.
Or is it a bunch of granada?
Well, I don't know. I'm sure Prestige will say he is a granada and a half. I think he would say that. Right? And he's demonstrating likewise. Emotion you all can't see, ladies, but you can just imagine what he goes on with, because on a Tuesday night you do hear him, all right, on music. Right? So Daddy Rude, you're a granana. Well. And Mondays as well, right? You're a granana, right? Right, Daddy Rude.
I was just interfered. Yes, and
we're not hearing you, maybe.
Yes, we're not hearing.
Prince.
I don't know. Handsome Prince is also with us, can I tell you?
And I'm avoiding answering your question, so you should have realized.
Oh,
that.
No, I didn't. I conveniently didn't. Anyways, listeners, ladies, tonight Daddy Rude is avoiding answering if he's a granana or not. Can you imagine? Anyways, good to have you all on board tonight. I know you guys sit up and you lie down and you tune in and so on and so forth to the show right up until 12, most of y'all. So thank you very much for that. Let me just say big ups to my friend Chris right now in New York. Big up yourself, Chris, and to Gracie over there in Georgia, and to everybody else across the United States of America, that is. Those in New Jersey, yeah. Those in Florida, hey Fitzroy. Where? Long Bay, of course, in Jamaica, Long Bay. Can I tell you? Colors, all right. Listening in, Shotta Jr. and Style. Okay, all right. Good to have you on board, Colors. Must be very beautiful, right? Or handsome, all right. Good to have you on board, guys. And keep it locked, all right. So big ups to everybody over there in the States, in Canada. Big up yourself all the time, every time. And of course, those right here in Jamaica who are listening in tonight. Yeah, good to have you on board. It's a holiday night. Yes, it's of course Heroes Day right in Jamaica, where of course we celebrate all our national heroes. And of course, let me say to all the people out there who have not been saluted as national heroes, but you're a hero in your own right. Big up yourself. Those who have saved someone from drowning, or ever saved someone from a burning fire, or something like that, or anything close to that. Big up yourself for being the hero in your community, in your relatives' lives. But those who have been holding it down for their loved ones, whether they are sick or, you know, bedridden or so on, and you've been there as their hero, big ups to you right about now, all right?
Today, I was nominated International Hero.
Ooh, nice.
Well, Daddy Rude was not UL.
Oh, Daddy Rude was not UL.
Daddy Rude was nominated.
Daddy Rude or UL?
Daddy Rude.
That sounds like something that UL would have gotten, and not Daddy Rude. For what, rudeness? I'm just checking.
I think some would agree with you with that one. So maybe that was not a robot for rudeness.
Oh, rudeness. Oh, boy. Of course, to Charm and to Drake, Mr. and Mrs. Drake. Big up yourself. You're always locked in. R&B Barbershop in the UK, always locked in. No matter what time we're starting out or ending out, we see you online and you're doing your thing. And we love it. We love it. We love it, right? Alright, let me give you some numbers now to hook us up. In case you're a first timer tonight, let me tell you the numbers to hook us up. And in case you don't remember, here is the local number, 453-1444. That's 453-1444. And if you're overseas and wish to call us later on in the show, that number is 954-338-7973. That's 954-338-7973. And we have some numbers in the UK, USA, and Canada on the go numbers. And those numbers tonight are, for the USA, it's 213-992-4360. That's 213-992-4360. And if you're in the UK, the number is 033-00103322. That's 033-00103322. 3322. And I'm missing a number, aren't I? Yes.
Canada.
Canada number.
Yeah,
and
we'll get
that
soon.
One is...
Yeah, we'll get that soon.
In a sec, we'll give you that one. That one is not flashing back in this head right now.
Yeah.
Can I tell you how those feet kind of... You know,
under the weather.
Yeah, man, the sinusitis thing kicking up. You know, them kind of feelings there. Yeah, not so pleasant, but no, holding it down.
I mean, you know, he's a girl where I always push through the
show.
Yeah, at
least. I'm a heroine.
At least.
I'm a heroine.
Heroine
in my own right.
Hero, H-E-R-O-I-N?
E. I think.
Cross off the E.
Why?
Because you behave that way sometimes.
And of course, the Canada number is 647-957-9637. That's 647-957-9637. I'm a thuggy girl, you know. I'm a dainty but thuggy girl.
I don't know about that. Maybe.
And I ain't no walk over. I'm no pushover.
Huh. No, your head at on a different level still.
As if
you're on
heroin. You know? No, I don't do drugs around here.
You heard that? You were listening to that thing that was playing.
Oh, yeah.
In the earlier part, that lady.
Yeah. Power.
I mean, I agree with her none at all.
Powerful.
I don't agree with her.
Why
in the
not?
In the first part, the other part fine, but the part, I mean, as man we not. It don't make you a real man because of this, and it make you a real man because
excuse
of
me,
that.
That was a real talk, sorry.
No, what a part there.
And this is the show.
I have something for
talk.
You to read later on in
let
the show.
Let me not anticipate it, I swear.
No, it's
last week I gave you something to read that I wasn't anticipating reading.
Oh, the whole the fluid bit.
The fluid story, yes, man. Yeah. So this evening you come now excited. Oh, something to give you to read. I'm not looking forward to it until I see it.
I have something I want to talk to you about.
Oh boy, here we go, listeners.
We have
YMCM, big up, thugger, thugat. And Miller 9, big up yourself. All right, yes.
Yeah. You know, me have a major issue in terms of...
Oh, yes, sir. Major issue?
Yeah.
What make? Ladies, I'm not prepared for this, but go ahead.
Let me ask you a question. And as someone who want the bridge them really and truly listen to what
I... Why are you bashing in your question? We are uno.
Just listen, please.
Okay.
Please. For once,
oh, boy.
Submit.
Submit.
Oh,
what an interesting
right.
word. Husa.
Husa.
All right.
Please. Now, I have an issue in terms of looking back at some things where I've experienced
mm-hmm.
and some reason where I'm a bridging with a hole. And a lot of other people, especially bridgings guys, go through this.
Mm-hmm.
There's this thing with women always... Okay. What?
I'm submitting. That's my way of submitting.
All right. And a real though. Women always be expecting guys to give them things, wanting things from us, right? And they always want, and we will give. But they'll take things from you,
mm-hmm.
and they'll, well, let me do it properly.
Please do.
They'll request things from you.
Yes.
We'll give it to them, and they'll take it from us,
mm-hmm.
right? And again, all of them say, boy, oh, I just my friend. Me and him not in a nothing. Right? But no, Cass, listen to that part, yeah.
You're going to Cass now or you're coming still up with me?
More on Cass, listen, because Cass been busy since because he have minor technical difficulties where he fix.
Mm-hmm.
But more on him hear that part, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Cass, woman always want to take things from man, right? And no strings attached. I just my friend. Nah, Sam, I'm not with him. But the same woman there,
mm-hmm.
right? The moment she...
Mm-hmm.
I wonder if it's too early.
Yes, it's too early.
I wonder if it's too early. The moment she give you the something,
mm-hmm.
she start declaring, say, you're not there. That can't work.
Oh.
It can't work.
So, aren't you the one who has always alluded that if a man is intimate with a woman like that, or they've gone to third base, then that makes her his woman?
No. You crazy? That's what
does it make her?
The same, we don't know nothing. I just my friend.
No. When you reach third base with a woman, what does she just that make her?
No, that's my friend.
So you go around and go to third base with all your friends?
I just my friend.
I'm asking you no. if you go and go to no. third base with...
No,
no. But that would mean you can't go every to third base with all your friends then.
I know every friend you share everything with.
But friend of friend. So you should share everything with the every same friend way, then if that be the
well,
case.
Well, I know our asset with money is of so much meaning to us as men.
Not so to much all means of you, to us all as men, to right? So you don't mind giving it away to the women so and flourishing them with it?
The same way with you, you know, I make you feel good. I want to say, I just my friend. That so way I make you know now. Nobody feels say when you don't give it a thing. It means say we're in a something.
Oh,
when
so you're equating a woman's intimacy I'm not with money?
I'm not equating it. What I'm saying to you is that say women need to stop, have that expectation. Oh, through that thing they go on, you know, and the man there. It's now 9:30. We can continue after 9:30. Well, we don't have to continue.
We shall.
The time is brought to you by VJ Printing Services. And remember, Real Talk is sponsored by Bayview Eco Resort and Spa, located in Dolphin Bay, Port Antonio, Portland. We're so forward.
Architects, draftsmen, and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high-quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for a presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VJ Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer-aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high-quality white paper printing that is water-resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
Bayview Eco Resort and Spa, boasting amenities such as restaurant, bar, spa, conference area, and swimming pool, were perfect for a business trip or vacation. Make a reservation today by calling us at 993-3118 or email us at bayviewecoresortspa@gmail.com.
Bayview Eco Resort and Spa, a sponsor of Real Talk with Daddy Rude and Lady Cleo. Monday nights, 9 p.m. till 12 midnight.
Builders Depot, everybody go a Builders Depot. Portland number one hardware, that's a Builders Depot. You want to fix up your yard?
Builders.
You could be living abroad?
Builders.
Hurricane season come?
Builders.
To make your roof blow a dung?
Builders.
We have the best pricing?
Builders.
The best parking,
Builders.
Harbor Dash, we are waiting. And we are carrying the swing.
Builders Depot, right Builders. At Industrial Estate Longwall in Burns Bay. I call them at 715-3128 or 284-3337. Check them out.
WAW, the Caravan of Love. What a Wednesday! This and every Wednesday from 9 a.m. until 1 on the p.m. Strongly takes you on a Caravan of love songs. 4 hours of love songs on Stars FM, the People's Station, 96.1, 96.7, www.stylzfm.com. Don't miss it. What a Wednesday, the Caravan of Love.
And a Love Break half-hour segment between 12:30 to 1 p.m. is sponsored by Save on Snacks and More.
Do you have or are you seeking a place to rent, seeking employment, or have a job vacancy? Are you selling a car or having a garage sale? Then come see us. Let Styles do the advertising for you and you'll be on your way in no time. Contact us at 876-286-9216 or 439-5160. Advertising style. Advertise with Styles.
Welcome back, guys, to Real Talk. And of course, my co-host says pretty much that when a woman gives it up to a man, it doesn't mean that they are together or that she is his woman or that them day. And Charm is in agreement with that statement.
Thank you very much, Potos.
But then Gracie says...
You don't need to read that.
Gracie says, loud and clear, turn up my volume, please. Yeah. Friends with a benefit. So if it is that he can take from a woman, and why can't he then give freely to a woman? And if he can take from her and she's just a friend, then why can't she just take from him and just be a friend just the same?
That me I say?
Really?
Is that what they say?
Really?
How many they say? How many say?
Look here.
How many say? The
moment you go with a woman,
yeah,
and you reach third base, it has become an intimate state.
Well,
and it's time the men stop taking women stop taking yourselves for granted that if a man sleeps with you, then it's just nothing.
No.
You're sharing something more than just a communication, more than just a drink, more than just a chit-chat session, more than even a touch or a little cuddle. It's more than that. You're gone to that place where nobody has gone before. That a different realm when you go in there, you know, where you're exchanging, because that's what you laugh about. You exchange all kind of something, body fluids, chemistry. When you just stop taking this lovemaking thing or this sexual encounter thing for, it's like it's trivial to so many people.
I'm not saying it's trivial.
Yes, you are saying it's trivial.
No, I'm not saying it's trivial. What I'm saying is that it is unfair, right, for a woman to keep asking for things, begging things, or have that expectation. Just like what the lady said,
but
the pastor.
But he either gives to her or he doesn't give it to her.
Just like what the pastor woman said, it takes a real man for give this, a real man for do that, and a real man for
rare. But if she wants it, she's going to ask for it, right? And if he can give her, he gives. If he can't give it to her, just can't give it to her. It's simple.
A lot of the things that women put on the table, say what a real man, a definition for a real man, are so unrealistic. Right?
So
now, when you ask or make requests from a man, and then a man give you something because, quote unquote, him like you. But all we can go on in your mind is say, oh, I just my friend, or I just my boopsie, or every time you want something from him, that's all. Anytime you want something, I him at the purse where can rap back pan, I just my friend. Now, what's wrong with when you run the thing and a man just see it and say, yo, I just my friend?
No. Equate whatever she gave you, ask back for things. And if you get them, well, it's just your friend. You can't use
no, but we don't want nothing else.
You're right about that.
Yeah, we don't want nothing else.
Except sex.
Yeah.
Oh,
I just
my
friend.
Goodness gracious. Ooh. That a rule I can't take it sometimes. That's what Lisa says. That Lisa,
Lisa
I concur. I concur, Lisa.
Lisa.
Oh boy. I know, Lisa. Anyways, Nova Peru in Illinois. She's locked in. Big up yourself, Nova. Good to have you on board. That a rude.
Yes.
I cannot agree with you that a woman's sexual encounter is just I just my friend. And I'm not. I just my friend. So that would mean if every woman were to give it up to you, it would just be, oh, I just my friend. And
no.
I'm nothing to it.
No.
I'm asking.
No.
It wouldn't be?
No.
But aren't they your friends?
Yes, but not all of them you're going to put in that category.
No, but if they all say, Daddy Rude, I want to throw this on you, baby, like you've never seen before, and I want to give it up to you, and
but
I want
to
this.
I also have the right to turn her down and tell her, no, I'm not interested.
So why not turn on all your friends then?
No, hold on.
Why don't you preserve the friendships and just turn them down when it comes to sex?
Me kind of did left it up before, but me realized I should still talk about it. You're talking about female friends.
Definitely.
Right? Okay, we'll just have to clear up that, you know. Burn up, you know. Brr.
Charm says, Cleo, I exchange. Cause nobody no love again. It's just exchange. No, Charm. No.
Look,
there is love, honey.
Well, I have a reason with one of my sister in our day. And we are talking about back in the days when you love off smaddy. When you go to school and you love off smaddy. You can't even talk, you know.
That was different. That was infatuation.
Yeah, what? It doesn't matter. It did feel good. You walk on the corridor and you see the girl, you just turn back. You can't pass the man in crew because everybody knows say you're an idiot for her.
Oh, my goodness. Those,
them time
that exists again.
Them time they are different something.
That may exist.
Nowadays, what a woman expect from a man is so unrealistic, and we try our best, and we could have done every single sanitary one of them except one thing. And we're just not good. So I'm saying, why is it that when a woman, I'm going to ask the question again, why is it that when a woman, the moment you and her get intimate, she automatically believe, for some reason, that she is now your woman or want of your woman.
Because when a woman gives up herself like that,
then we don't give up nothing. We don't give up something to.
Actually, no.
What do you mean, no?
To how you guys view it and how you men relate
no,
to
no,
it.
No, not, no, no.
To how you men relate about it is like nothing.
Take away how we...
I can't take that away because you're the ones who foster us to think and to believe what we believe. Because you men... I mean, it is said that generally speaking, men are dogs. Let me put it this way.
And dogs are loyal.
Generally speaking, men are dogs.
And dogs are loyal.
Except for the loyal part of it. Yeah, you're not loyal. Needless to say. All right. So men will and can engage with a woman sexually and feel nothing.
Of
absolutely
course.
Nothing. For the average woman.
Hold on.
The average woman. Yes, of course was right, darling. Of course was right. The average woman.
We feel
the
nothing?
Moment. Feel nothing at all. No. I mean, all you feel is yourself ejaculating and reaching that climax, but that's it.
Okay.
You can separate emotions from a sexual encounter. For the average woman, she cannot make that distinction. Some women, mark you, who have programmed themselves to just engage in the act and cut off from it afterwards, they can manage it.
All right, hold on.
But the average, ordinary woman, the moment she gets into a man sexually... There is an attachment for her.
All right, let me try and understand something. All the time, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 months, this lady been asking the person, the man, for things, right? And the man been doing all these nice things, pick her up, courting, all them something that he has been doing. Big man thing, after a while, it's worn out. He might not have that kind of... feeling fear anymore. But then she finally decides to boy, okay, she'll give it to him after him pass that, right? So him never go first base, second base, but now in a one night all bases loaded. And things go on. Why is it that all of a sudden after all that torture him go through, he must say, okay, fine, yeah, I'm a girl now?
Because I'm saying to you, for the man and for the woman, it's totally different. The men view things differently, and
even
so
if
do
it's
the women.
Are you saying that that's how it's supposed to be? We're supposed to say, okay, yes, I'm a girl now. I'm asking you.
Okay. I'm not going to just
Because not because the woman feels they are so, you're going to mean, say, we have to accept it, so.
I agree. But you have to understand, though. That's one of the problems. You say we don't understand the relations that we are engaging ourselves into.
I mean,
men have to understand that from a woman's perspective, she is going to think and feel differently. And I'm speaking generally now.
Hold on. Remember what I said.
Psychologically decided that
the moment
she wants to share her body
moment
with this man in this
a man
way.
Deep in her pocket, him start feel like a fame woman that because right away I'm minding my mind her. I'm going to smile if I'm minding your woman. That may I make you know.
But the men do not feel that way. They think they're exchanging money for sex.
Well, no.
They
no,
think they're giving
no,
her up
no,
to try
no,
to bribe
no.
her or to buy her into giving it up.
Oh.
I've heard a man say, not, I've heard reported speech now.
Okay.
I've heard that a man said, yeah, he meets a woman and he really likes her. And he must show her interest. He must take out all money. Kyla money, and of course, give her. Back in the 90s and so on.
When things
and
would have gone. Went,
and then those times money was, 10,000 was like an old money. Yeah?
Mean.
And he would give her the first dose. That's what we're going to call it. The first dose of the money. Yeah? And she thinks, ooh, wow. Now is my time to like probably get in. Or she eventually gets in with him because she thinks, okay, here's somebody who will take care of me
That's
and support
our
me.
Fault.
Support me. And then guess what happens? The moment she gets into him,
the same
all
thing,
that he used to do, just cut off.
The same way the pastor woman I preached
so
about a
you
while
you don't
ago.
Mind giving up the money, really and truly. You don't mind.
No, you can't use one person.
No, but you all right? Really and truly do not. Oh my God, my
but, well,
money.
You
I'm
don't
give
mind
to her. I'm minding her because
yeah,
she's my
yeah,
girl.
Yeah, but let me ask a question.
No,
but women don't mind taking it.
Why should they? Or why would they?
Okay.
Do you know of any woman who would say, okay, this man and
so,
I are communicating?
So ladies and germs.
Oh please.
It go right back to where me say, them have an agenda. We have an agenda. Right? And pretty much, as far as me see it, the same way how we dip in our pocket and a woman say, boy, she want a man for care for her. You give her this, you pick her up from work, you carry her to work and all them something there. You start
What's wrong with treating a woman nicely? What's
start,
wrong with that?
Start,
That's lacking in our society where
you
some men don't do that.
To take care of her from early out. Now, there should be nothing wrong if when a woman decides that she's going to finally take care of you, because he used to say, boy, oh, he's just my friend, he's just my friend. So when she finally decides that she's going to take care of one of your needs, and you declare to her, say, baby, you're just
Why
my friend, you're just my friend.
Why does it have to be the sexual need? There are other needs that men should have.
Like what?
Oh my God. Ladies, are you telling me that men, the only need that men have is that for sex?
Give me
is
an
that
example.
Need for sex?
Give me, well, number one.
Companionship.
On an aspect.
Moral support. Come on.
Well, we don't need moral support.
You oh?
know, no, we don't need moral support. We need you to support.
Friendship should be where
no, no, hold on.
Anything Cass, starts from the beginning.
Cass, see, you see it? You see,
Daddy Rude.
You see she paused, she looked at the sky about
no,
a fifth.
No, because right, I'm
Cass,
saying,
well, I know, the man must support, and all the man can get from a woman is moral support.
No, man,
who wants support, man?
Other forms of support. She should also be able to spend on him, carry him to dinner. Yeah, buy him a shirt, a nice pants.
So why you wink so fast when you say that part?
I'm not winking.
What's your guess? Well, I'm sure the people...
A woman is supposed to be able to do similar things for her man, for the man that he does for her.
And if she's not able to do it, what?
Then she do other things like cook dinner for him. Rub his feet when he comes home from work. You know,
no,
give him a massage.
You have my attention. Go on.
Talk. Yes, I understand these things. You know.
Well,
I know. I get these things.
She's supposed to do it, but do they do it? Let's talk about that part.
And okay.
Let's
and if
talk
they,
about that part.
And if
because
they don't,
obviously, yes,
the
obviously,
men,
obviously,
well,
it's,
man.
Obviously, it's compulsory for a man financially take care of a woman.
It is supposed but to be compulsory for the woman to take care of the man too. I do not agree with the women who don't take care of
the
man.
You hear the operative word? Supposed to be.
Yes, it should be. If he can support me and treat me nicely. And,
no, no,
and,
what, why can't I say if he's supposed to treat me? You see, you left
okay,
the supposed apart.
Because we are saying that.
No, man, more keep it leveling up.
We are saying the hypothetical situation is where you're saying that the man already does
even
it.
Like the hypothesis business.
The man already does it. The man is doing it presently, right? And I'm saying it is supposed to be a case where the woman do the same thing for the man. So it shouldn't be a case where, okay, he's supporting her, he's buying her stuff, giving her money, but then whenever he wants the sex, it's just sex he must want because he's doing all these things for her. Absolutely not.
But maybe that's all she has to offer because you're not.
Are you saying a woman only has sex to offer a man?
Well, on, Cass, hear this now. That's it.
I'm no. asking well,
I know.
You.
Well, I know.
You better not look at me like that, Cassidy.
Cass. Well, I know. Listen.
Oh, my
Cass.
Goodness.
When I get the massage, the bump, the nose squeeze.
You should.
The foot now rub down. So what else left? Forget.
Ask for it
see,
the same way the woman
I've been correct all
no,
this
no, no, no.
time.
The woman asks what she wants. As a man, if you're not getting it, demand it and ask what you want.
So why can't I get it elsewhere? Argument done.
Well,
think about that part. Think about that part.
How about stop doing what you're doing for her and find somebody else who will reciprocate and be with them then?
Years of investment, you just make it go so. You must be mad.
So why would you be there for years?
You must be mad.
Why would you be there for years when this woman is not doing jack for you?
Because at
really?
The time, we thought.
So all you want is just a nookie?
We thought.
It's that good.
We thought all of these things
see,
were coming.
You think with your titties. And your grananas, that's a problem.
That's not a problem.
It is a problem.
That's not a problem.
Let's see what the WhatsApp messages are saying, please. Marie says, that's the difference between men and women. Men see sex as trivial, while women see it as something else.
Marie.
Yes. Cadian.
Holy rude.
Cleo, give Daddy Rude a lick or a slap for me, and I can't call the word. So early. Friend of friend, stay in the friend line. I agree, Cadian. If she's your friend, you don't cross certain boundaries like sexual boundaries. Thank you.
Let's see what Yakisha is saying.
Yakisha from Texas saying, hey team, hey girl, how you doing? Here's where we can find common grounds in this discussion. Have a pre-discussed, pre-agreed arrangement before an intimate encounter.
I like that
so
far.
This way, nobody can have no problem. No overly high expectations. I agree with you, Yashika.
We can't agree
and can
with
I tell you many times,
Yakisha.
Many times, that's the problem. We don't
Women break the contract.
Or there was no pre...
Women break the contract.
judging of anything or preconceived
anything. Let's see what Grace says.
Anything. Good night, Lady Cleo and Daddy Rude. Night, darling. Hey, Cassidy, Prestige and Prince. Oh, she knows what's going on in the studio. What was going on, rather. Cleo, it must have friend with benefit. Cleo, most time man wants all the pampering, and when them fi return the favor, them tired. Can I tell you, sister? So that's another issue to look at as well. Indeed. They want it all, and yet, when you must get it back, ladies, them tired.
The stress we all don't expect.
Stress you out where?
You know, the stress we out mentally.
Anyways. Let's see what Charm has to say. Daddy Rude too mean. No sleep with a woman or a man does mean that you and him de. Cleo a exchange, cause nobody no love again, it's just exchange. Sex exchange for money for what you can do for each other. There are some people who are in those relationships, yeah?
Yep.
But if a guy doing things for me, still, I kind of want to do back things. I'm not going to use the sex and say, okay, I'm going to do this for me, so the sex. And he shouldn't be expecting that. Okay, but
realize, Akisha, realize that you were trying to be diplomatically correct.
Kadeen said, no boob sitting around here.
That me I talk about, rude boy.
But Kadeen won't have enough girls, so I'm sorry for him. Because some of them shall boob him out. Lisa says,
Nova. Oh, that's Peru.
Let's see what Lisa says.
Oh, you read that already?
Okay.
So she can't take
you. Can't take you sometimes, yes. Clay, too, says good night. Good night to you, too, Clay.
Big up R&B Barbershop.
Yes, indeed. And Drake. Is it Drake or Mrs. Drake? Hello. Mrs.
Drake.
What happened to Real Talk? Okay. Okay, we're on. We're on, darling. We're on. All right. So we're going to go to the...
So, one of the things still... More... Say, what one of the things we realized though, outside of this topic is that, say, in you know, sometimes you send some vibes. You know, like, say, you and somebody talk on the phone and you just pick up on energy, say, there's a change in a way you used to. You know, you probably call all, yeah, all your person or so on, or you'd have normally WhatsApp or whatever on the one, though, Skype. But then you feel a different vibes, you know?
It's just a distant vibe.
A distant vibe, like they're not dead. You know, you try to talk to them where you're there. Some kind of dry answers, nothing specific, you know? You soon come home. Me busy. What you doing? Work. You know? Why so late? Nothing. Them kind of thing.
Those are flags. Red ones.
Red flags. Red flags.
That's a message.
How you are reading or something like that? You call up bossy and bossy start like...
Him doing can't answer. But then again, he would argue, why would I answer in the first place?
All right. For argument's sake, you know, same around the road and you normally hear music playing in the background. This time now, you're not hearing no music. You pick up on them something to your pre them thing there?
You can ask that? That's a rhetorical question.
Not. So.
In a position where they're doing something, well, quote unquote, wrong in your eyes, would they have answered the phone in the first place? Or some may argue that I answer so that he or she knows that, okay, I can answer. However, what comes next is what gives you some kind of doubt because they're not answering the way that you'd expect them to answer.
And the conversation might not be going
right.
The way how it used to. You know, I hear, yeah, baby, I love you, and all them. So them the language, yeah, you can't talk again.
In an uncomfortable zone, sort of.
Yes.
That would give me...
How would you deal with that?
No one know where you're there, no. I'm going to come right there where you're there right now. Right there and now. If I can get there, I'm going to get there. I want to know where you are. Yeah, so I can come and wait on you or whatever. Yeah. I'll come by.
So, what me up on the road in the moms?
And if you're that far, I'm just not come for the phone right now. I don't want to come for the phone. I want to stay on the phone with you till you... Whatever you are going to do,
so how would
you can't bother do it.
Let me ask you a question. How would you do it? Would you make it obvious that you suspect someone? Would you try to be more insistive? How would you do it?
It all come up, man. I have to come out to me. I suspect something. I'm annoyed.
You just can't hold it.
Can't hold it back. So what, hey, what's up? What you doing? You all right? Yeah. So where you there?
Pony road.
Pony road where?
My drive, you know.
Yeah, so where you go?
Up on a road.
So where you go? So where you can't tell me where you go?
I soon come on, man.
No, I never ask you that. I ask you where you go. Where you can't tell me where you go?
Up on my road.
Oh. All right, so stay on your route, you know? Stay on your route, man. No worry yourself. Because anywhere you're there, me can do that too. Anywhere you are go, me can go there too. You don't worry yourself.
So you're going to come by me on the road?
No worry yourself. Stay where you're there, and me will go where me I go, and me will stay where me I go. You don't worry about it.
All right,
me
have a drop off, so.
Yes, man. Drop off all you want, my love. All you want, drop.
So why you act up? Yeah, over.
No, because you're the one, you're girl, then you can't answer, you can't talk to me, so you come to me the pan route. You don't normally talk to me, so. When me are talking, normally tell me where you're there, and where you're going to do, or whatever. All of a sudden, no, you're the pan route, and you're this, that. No, and you're human, I go out. Are you the human, you can't answer me? Of course, this is me now going into zone where. Listeners! That rule don't draw me out.
So alright, fine. Yes. No, I'm reach home.
Cleo, did you hear the car engine? Actually, no, Grace. You don't hear no engine.
Grace, how you doing?
No engine, my love. Well, lock up in a house and in a room or wherever they can't talk.
No, but they can't have AC. What's wrong?
Engine,
where are you
lock off.
Well, they can't have AC. So, reach home. Oh, alright. What would
you...
Where
if you come home later than expected, my mama? After I talk to you, you'll come home one good couple of hours after that.
But let me ask a question.
Oh, boy.
Boom. Me get Bex, me hang up the phone. Would you call me back?
Judgment. At the worst part, that. This is where L breaks loose.
Are you calling back? Voice message.
That's not going to be good.
Battery dead.
Make it battery come on back. Make it come on at the wrong time for you, but you're dead, my love. At the wrong time, conveniently dead. It can't work.
No, but it happened. You know that this happens.
It can happen.
No. I mean, the whole thing. It happens. A lot of people go through this.
Why your battery have to die in the same breath when me?
Because you talk it off.
Where were you all along to have charged your battery in the vehicle while you were driving? You have a charger in the car. Why not charge your battery then?
But it's not
you come out of the car and gone somewhere else, probably now one out and now one hotel, gone lock up for how long? And you don't carry the charger, apparently. Yeah? If you charge it up, you're so busy getting into you know what and getting under you know where that you forget both phone and charger.
So let me ask
that
question.
And me no car, you know, all of a sudden phone battery dead. Lord help you.
But moms, what do you when it in a class, I'm a call and I get you. No battery, no battery dead. Why do you with your phone and my phone?
Jackie in Canada says, Cleo, same way them stay. Can I tell you, Jackie? Kevin in Florida. Hi, Kevin. How you doing? You to a sample. I don't know why I'm pulling my tongue, you know, Kevin. I don't know. But on a very serious note, though, men, and them can't lie, you know. Hey, can I tell you how the men, a folk girl, they'll be at home with the wife or the girlfriend.
Have you ever been in the position where you are the one who couldn't communicate straight?
Yes, man.
How you deal with it?
Come with my phone. You mean with a partner?
Yeah.
No. Never been in that situation. Okay. I've been in a situation where you're with your partner and somebody who can, you know, check you away, call and wants to go into a conversation.
Oh.
Yes. And you're just not able to even... It's discomforting to have to. Then, you don't want to really insult them either.
Then why you can't understand that?
I didn't say I can't understand.
Would you, for argument's sake, would you take it as well? You said already, say it's a red flag.
Yeah.
Would you? What if it's a young relationship?
With a partner.
Mm-hmm. Would you stay? Or is not enough reason for you to leave?
Oh, young. Third base gone?
Then listen, third base gone.
May I ask a question?
Yeah, I mean, in the most.
Third base gone, holy patina. Holy patina.
Me no know. I'm if you know. Third base gone.
Enough time.
Young relationship. Young relationship. No, young. You see it? Young relationship in terms of say 5 months, 6 months, less than a year.
If this happens frequently, then I'm gonna think twice, honestly. But if it's a one-off shot thing, I'm gonna get mad at it, and miss it. You know, really, you know.
You think a man would deal with it the same way, or would you want us to deal with it the same way?
Maybe.
You must be mad. You know, maybe. 10 o'clock, make your song come. You're mad. You must be mad.
I think you guys would splurt.
Of course.
But is that enough for you to splurt?
Look here, we know we out that. You think I scale?
Look here. The women have...
Listen, hold on.
A lot of women who tolerance, some men
no,
are
no,
with...
No, you say tolerance where women was made of. We make with...
You're right, you know.
We make with that thing name arrogance.
A true
right, so we
darkness.
We're in a dark, we're in a no long argument. We make out a baking soda taste bad, bitter. Right? So we just explode. They said the phone drop and the chip and chip out.
Shanship, the shanship, sound exhausting. Yashika? Yakisha, rather. Yakisha. I keep calling you Yashika. Yakisha. The shanship's on exhaust. I'm not sure what the shan. The hashtag shanship. Dwight says, Daddy Rude, women stay so too.
And that me know, man. That me know. Them can't more than anybody else. The time is now 10 o'clock, ladies and gentlemen. And do remember that Real Talk is sponsored by Bayview Eco Resort and Spa. Time is brought to you by Fiji Printing Services.
Juki, big up yourself.
Big up, Juke Start.
Architects, draftsmen, and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high-quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VJ Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer-aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high-quality white paper printing that is water-resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
Calling all bars, calling all bars.
This is an all points bulletin.
It feels so good to be back.
It does feel so good to be back. Hey, what we call it again?
Bar Roundup Volume 2.
Yep, it's the 2016-2017 edition. Bigger, better, better than before.
You know, Styles FM DJ, I got dead for shell down the bar round up them.
And a simple maths, you provide the bar, we provide the entertainment, the advertising, and intermediate updates of the night proceedings from the venue.
For bookings, call 286-9216 or 993-3358. You know what I mean?
You can't afford to miss this one. Is
yes, I am up next.
Be wowed on Wow Factor, Mondays and Tuesdays, 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. It's informative, educating, and entertaining.
Wow! I feel good.
Put the joy of entertainment in your ears. Be a part of the Wow Factor on Styles FM.
Take us to work. Take us on a go. Take us wherever you go. Styles FM.
Take Styles FM with you on the go. The number for USA 213-992-4360. That's 213-992-4360. And for the United Kingdom, 033-0010-3322. That's 033-0010-3322.
Styles FM.
Bayview Eco Resort and Spa. Boasting amenities such as restaurant, bar, spa, conference area, and swimming pool, we're perfect for a business trip or vacation. Make a reservation today by calling us at 993-3118 or email us at bayviewecoresortspa@gmail.com.
Bayview Eco Resort and Spa, a sponsor of Real Talk with Daddy Rude and Lady Cleo. Monday nights, 9 p.m. till 12 midnight.
Yes,
welcome back, guys, to Real Talk, the show where we discuss everything real and nothing ideal.
Nothing ideal.
And can I tell you, oh, Shelly, or real. Shelly will get about this story.
Yep.
Shelly says, men are always on the road, ladies. Everlasting road. No destination, signposts, or anything. My conversation, Shelly says, would finish right there, right this abrupt. I wouldn't even know if him battery dead, because I wouldn't be calling him back. And when him get home, he would be afraid to even eat. Tom is sweet and smiling. Can you imagine, Shelley? Pick up yourself, Shelley.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you something straight, right? If you don't have Shelley contacts on WhatsApp and things, she's in a lovely, lovely dress, looking all good. Not like that was she right a while ago. So you're not really tempted for name from him. Believe you me. So, you know.
Oh,
me name never paid that, no mind. Right? Although she advocate for grandma's own. But, yeah, that no mind. Let's see what Yakisha is saying.
Yakisha is saying, but no relationship nah go on if I saw you would deal with him, Cleo. Hence, shanship. No relationship.
Oh, shanship. Mad. All right, we're going to go into the Vox Pop, ladies
Alrighty,
and gentlemen.
Thank
because
you guys for your input.
We have a sure said tonight scenario going to drive people crazy. So we want to run into the Vox Pop. I think we have a number of Vox Pop, right, Cass?
Mm-hmm. And here is the Vox Pop for tonight, peeps. Hello, Real Talk family. Am I wrong?
You're wrong. Not? That's the one.
Okay.
On the screen.
All right. This is a real relationship shaker, and I'd really like to get your views on this. Do you believe that you have the right to tell your partner that the relationship with his female friend or her male friend is too close for comfort, even though you've met them being that way? Or would you accept the "we're just friends" cliche and relax? So, in other words, Cassidy has a girlfriend, and before he met that girlfriend, right?
Yeah,
me and him that friend before, and we are bridging.
Yeah, party.
Right, and we chit chat just about everything, and we share just about everything. All right. Now him have this new girlfriend. Mm-hmm. Big up yourself, Kim. And Kim decides, so listen to me now, you know. You and Cleo too close, but can't deal with it.
Yeah.
Every day you not chat on phone,
yeah,
visitation and all this. You not go out. More than even me and you go out. It can't work. You not too close. So is it okay for her to tell him that him and Cleo just too close? Or
She just
accept, say, we're just friends. And relax, Bill. Go and chill.
Yeah.
How if you go? Hi. Whoa.
Straight up. I'm not even going a long thing. I'm not in that.
I'm not lying. People out there, listen to me now.
I'm not going to just tell her it off the top.
And I'm serious.
The boy, if you have manners.
Listeners. The girl if you have manners, and I serious no. No,
oh man, she can't.
I understand.
No, she can't contain
me. If
you
have double standard in your family, see? Keep quiet and relax.
Is it Bill?
Bill, all right. No, listeners, if it is that this man, your man, ladies, let me talk to you first. If your lady, if your man has some lady friends or a particular lady friend, whom he might not have been involved with at all, just him friend. Yeah, could very well just be him friend. Okay, some man where we talk to some girls with them friends,
or
them close,
or them did involved, but you just don't know and it done.
Right, but not friend, no. Right. Either way.
Yeah, cause we're not told to a friend like that, you know.
That one the worst. Anyways, but him and are just friend right now. Nothing now going between them. Now he meets you. I think both of them, the girl and the man, he should understand the kind of girlfriend or the kind of person that he has. And if it's somebody who would feel some level of discomfort with them being so close, he ought to understand that and respect that. And no, say, boy, while I won't malice or cut off my friend, because he's my friend, and you have to respect your friends, right?
Mm.
But I must also respect the fact that my woman is uncomfortable or not so pleased with the closeness.
Yo, hold on, man.
Hold on, man. I'm not finished. And the woman on the other hand should also understand that while it is that I'm going to still maintain my friendship with this dude, I can't expect if I go out with him or if she and her man go out and I'm there, I'm going to be all over him like I used to before when he was single. I'm going to be all up in his face. I'm going to be all up in her space. And no, no, no.
Hold on. Then I will get in her space.
And she... Look here. Girlfriend intimacy... Fiance,
no,
different
but
from
no, but girlfriend
social
intimacy.
Platonic
right,
friendship.
Right,
come
right.
on
but,
now.
But girlfriend
so
intimacy.
If you find a girlfriend, don't tell me that she's up in the platonic friendship space, because guess what? That's a whole different relationship from the one that he's now in. So if it was a case where you had a woman, an intimate woman before, and then she's now there, and you could have that say. Maybe.
I'm going to tell you something.
But friend of friend, do not mix the two.
I'm going to tell you something. You know what the difference with the man thing from the woman thing? You have some man they want to come prove by you. Right? You say, you and the man have a friend for a man, in, and him and your woman a friend. You know, my man come and come squeeze, I can tell all my woman, female, what's the problem with a female and a female girl? You know? That make you know, you know. My woman has stress out when she's supposed to like, massage my foot. Right?
But she so, ought to know that right she's not supposed to be stressed out over his problem either.
So
come on.
So right there, so the man supposed to know say him off a bounce, because let me show you something. You see, when you as a man have a woman, you have two work for do.
What's that?
You see, our best friend work become your work. Plus the work where you work, she. Two work you have to do. So, me no need no help to carry out my work. Me no need no help. So, him have to just easy back. No, say him and even. Him become four.
No friend around here.
Him become four because him go that one. Hey, tell us something, our friend Dangerous Cassidy. Yeah, me show friend Dangerous. He say, I know the woman a girl born. The friend know, you know. That may make you know, so we can't friend the friend. I mean, I want what if you're
maybe
face.
You should friend the friends, you can find out these
no.
things.
No, guess what? Can't make a woman friend with friend them neither. You must be mad, where are you at? You can't make a woman and friend your friend. Them have to be four. This is why I'm saying them have to be four, Cass. You can't make your woman friend your friend.
Listeners, are you listening?
Right? Vox Pop, yeah, Cassidy.
This should not be a deal breaker unless there is a trust issue. If they can converse in my presence without being secretive, then it's okay. People can have close friendship with the opposite sex as long as these relationships are secondary to mine. And these friends should show respect to our relationship.
I have the right to discuss with my partner things that I am uncomfortable with. And if he has a friend that I feel is too close for comfort, I will discuss it with him. And the same goes for me. It has to be mutual for the relationship to work. Okay?
If I met someone and he knew a female before me, even though it's just a friendly relationship, I'm not saying that they can't be friends, but I'm just saying once you know that that person is involved with somebody, you should just respect the space. You know, respect the space and don't get too close. You know, I was in a relationship like that before and I didn't see any respect there, because I mean, not even as much as the person that I was dating, is that the female was like, you know, don't know how to give some space, you know, don't know how to be respectful. And that's what I'm talking about. Just put yourself in the position and ask yourself, if it was you, how would you feel about it? You know, just be respectful and don't give me any reason to feel that, you know, you are too close to my boyfriend. You know, I mean, the whole thing about it is respect.
It's a really tough one, because I really and truly want to be able to trust my friend or trust my mate, so I don't know. That's a tough one.
I would not have a problem with him having female friends, but it would really depend
and the relationship they have. People do have friends, good friends. I have good man friends, so I know. Likewise, you have good female friends. But as you see, if you don't have your trust in a relationship, it's not gonna work. You have to have trust and don't have insecurity. Once you have insecurity and you not have trust, you're gonna have problem. But for me, I don't have no problem with that. Trust me. We have my man friend, then we have a woman friend, and that's good. I don't have a problem.
Oh, real talk is back with you. No. I didn't tell you with you at some point when she said insecurity issue and trust issue. I can trust the man. But maybe I'll trust issue with the woman. Because I didn't really know where she depend and why she think she has to be jumping up on him. I come into a party with him or a function with him and she's all over him. Like, why does she have to do that?
Like all a long time, they don't know one of that. Rotted.
And jump up and pop and his panja and all these
jump
things.
Jump and hug up and all them and something there.
No, man. No. My trust issue would be probably with her.
Yes. You can imagine, old boy. Your mom's a walk and a long time friend. CR, hey, walk go a long time and run and hug up and lift her up off her foot. You never do that for your bond
and
yet.
Spin her, and please. Spin with her, yeah.
Talk to you, road boy. Who you vexed with? You have a vexed smarty, you know. Who you have vexed with? No.
I would have vexed with him.
No, who you have vexed with? You have vexed with she?
She alone? She lift up
herself.
Exactly.
Who you have vexed with, Cass?
And did she expect the lift?
The man don't know you for true. The man don't know you, but him go lift her up.
It was unexpected. You can't blame her. She didn't expect her call for it.
You feel him should check himself before him do that? Or still?
Of course. He's an idiot.
But him not a call for impulse.
Impulse. It was an impulsive lick.
Remember, you know.
He's supposed to realize that she's with somebody.
But suppose that's how them greet them one another from long time.
No, that's what I'm saying.
From college days.
Yeah, but now she's with somebody. You don't know who this man is. You ought to be sensitive. Since evening, I was in a vehicle. Yeah? I was in boss's vehicle. And a man passed and said, boy, that girl, you look good, man.
Yeah.
Nah, lie, baby, you look good here. I smiled and I said, thank you. I'm in the business if your man want, chop me still, you know. But, me nah, lie, you look good. And since then, he came around and said, oh, are you? This day I said, oh, the girl on the front. No, the front seat look good, man. And I see me talking, you know. And the person to see it. No.
That's why he's trouble bosses still.
Probably troubling him, yes. And maybe he's, you know, that he saw him saying something to me. And he wanted him to know that, okay, I was just giving a compliment or whatever the case is. But let us say the person knew me. Coming to the vehicle side and talking to me is okay. But yo, and jumping in the car too and still and chat up to me. It just look away. You don't do that.
Why? You're a friend.
No.
You're a friend.
No. Oh. Your friend. Okay. If it is a friend of both of us and they want to come in the vehicle, if it's the man's close friend, yeah, and it's my friend too.
No, hold well on. Stop
that's
right there.
That's different.
Sir. Kias, stop right there, sir. Big man thing, Kias.
No, I can have a friend who is close to my partner as well.
No, sir. None of my friends them not close up. You're mad? No.
No, nothing is wrong with that.
What do you mean?
He has friends who I know who I chit-chat with.
Oh, you know. But a friend is supposed to come close up and come grounds out the place.
No. We have a call on 954. Hello, caller. Good night. Hello.
Yeah, listen to the computer.
Not hearing you, darling.
Talk to her. Oh, what go on put us?
Not hardly hearing you.
Oh, you sound so like you're under your weather.
Under
the
weather. Yeah. No. Even though I'm still there in New York, you hot at 83 degrees. It's not cold.
Hold on, you're not going back to the right place yet. Tropical place.
No, baby.
Look like sitting going for you up there now. Where are you dealing with? No, make me talk your business. What go on?
Anyway, you cannot see one of your friends for a long time and a man don't know what to say. And you're a man that.
Yes.
And come run and hug you, be excited to see you for a long time. He can be a friend from school, yes. he can be a friend from growing up. It both all grow up together.
Mm-hmm.
You don't know say your people that you want come hold you up. You understand?
Yeah.
So I know like
I yes, your man for us bill.
But at least me explain who it is or whatever.
You feel say owe him an explanation?
No, people have feelings. No, everybody has to take it like that. But honestly, you know, say you know want him to road come there. Because you know say your man, if the person know and react that way, it is different.
So hold on. But you feel say owe your man one explanation?
Of course.
Yes. Exactly. Maga want to know who that.
Why, Charm, I tell you the truth tonight. If one of my ex cat didn't come run and hug me up, and I never know what I tell mom saying. I tell you the truth tonight. Better me just go on. I don't know as godly vet. I think about it now. I don't know what I'm doing, Charm.
Really?
What, Charm? How me look at mom and say, boy, you know, that one cat with me use a bunks?
No, Jesus.
Charm, you idiot. I'm a friend. What kind of friend? Charm. When I try to find information, you know, only lead with you tell more lie, you know.
I'm a school years friend.
So when you used to go on with that school, I saw when you used to chummy at school. till it all bunks over till now.
Yes, I'm a school years friend. You know, mom's having to know your ex.
Why, Charm? You sound like the woman who had a scratch on the phone when the man have tried to find out which part she there. Later. Cool.
And as you say, we always say, I just my friend. Yeah, that's my friend. So,
run on next.
But the friend, the boyfriend,
yeah,
ought to be respected, or the girlfriend.
I mean.
So the man who's not here for a long time, not supposed to just run out and jump up on you just so. Yeah?
You know, when I think about the case, I still don't trust all that neither. Because people have like a way where they make like a sign, you know. They have like a way where they make like a sign. You know, two people have a little connection. You say, worse if it's all a little man where one little something did go on. They have like a sign. They know them code where you can't make no move. You know?
Box owe him.
Box swap. Yeah, laugh.
You must prove that that's your genuine friend and not sweetheart.
If my partner and I have a strong bond in which we can communicate effectively and trust each other, then I must can trust him with his female friend. Remember, she is his friend before I met him. So if he was interested in her, no way could I be his partner. Trust is the key ingredient in a relationship.
Yeah, that's the rule that then I do, you know. He's there before. And they are friends from way back, Wapikid, Fila, or whatever. But at the end of the day, I wasn't in her life. He was, even as friends and them not in touch, you know what I mean? But me supposed to get the status as best friend in your life. Me supposed to be a man, me supposed to be a comfort, me supposed to be the person where you want to run to first in any situation, pending on the relationship that we have. However, I won't have a problem with them having a chat on the phone or yell up or whatever. But when, if my come on the gate, come stand up and shout out, make you go road or make you go sit down and chat or make you go this or that can't go work out. You understand what I mean? My time and my time. And if you want to see him on the road and talk to him, fine. But nobody left me out, say I go down to your friend yard. That can't work out. If it's a woman, fine. Go and go spend the whole day. But nobody tell me, say I go left and go down to Roger yard. Go sit down and I go left and go down to daddy road yard. That can't record. Tell me about your daddy with a best friend from way back. She got a daddy with a daddy. No, sir. Big up yourself, real talk family. You remember I said to you now, daddy with. Yeah, you remember them like I said to you. I'm direct it to the audience. You said that the thing that daddy would, that come like a rhetorical thing right there, sir. You understand what I mean? Because if she and him move too close, she would have known him all before me. Once them start move too close and shaky, I'm see the shakiness. That after break up, man, we talk about that dude. That not supposed to go on. She's supposed to respect the relationship. Or that the man is supposed to respect the relationship. You know? Oh, to a friend, you're going to make friend mash up a relationship then, basically. So I must see your friend asleep at night time then. That can't work out, that dude. If I see no closeness to that and a male friend, so to speak. Yeah, you hear me? I'm going to stay there, male friend. Yeah, man, go post office with a male friend. I'm not depend on that.
Why that would yes, my feel some have a right to tell them that yes. Say him and him female friend too close. Me not uncomfortable with always stay still. Me do it one time though, but me regret it. Me regret it, man. At the same time, you need to get it off your chest, just let the person know say you're uncomfortable with the with how close him the with him and female friend still, cause you know make no sense you have it on your heart.
True. Clear your heart, my girl. Clear your heart.
but let me ask the question. What if, what if you actually tell the person and the person still insists that they might keep them friendship? You're uncomfortable with the way of them are rolling, you know? But how would you deal with something like that?
Just roll the same way with my friends.
What kind of business is that?
Equality.
No, but if you never have no friend close like that, you
can't. I have friend close all the time, but my friend and me, they respect him. And say, look, this is my guy. He knows it's my guy. There are certain things my friend, who should be smart enough to know, that there are certain things you don't do to disrespect your girlfriend's man. And me, not going to do certain things with my friend either, because I'm respecting my man.
You know, sir.
So if it is that him can't respect me with him friend team. To hell with him, and I do my thing, him do him thing. We have a caller on 453. Hello, caller. Good night.
Oh, Daddy Road. Where are you going?
Yo.
Where are you going?
There on the road, boy.
Long time no hear you, man.
Why? We just go and build back, you know?
Yeah, well, that's right now. But that thing, you know, Daddy Road. I go with me, I go at the same time, you know.
Where are you going?
Me and my man don't have a man come fuck her up. I'm great. I go, man. I'm trouble a yard, man. You're mad, man.
So, let me ask you, caller. If that had happened to you, would you expect her to go home?
Well, you flip it thing.
Me have you flip it? It have you flip?
Look.
No, man. That is the problem with you men. Only love turn things one way too much. May I ask you, caller, on a serious note, caller, big and serious, you go out on a category, you know, from long time this who did like you. Not never go on, you know, but she like you long, long time. And she see you come in the place, and you go buy a little drink. Your girl is nearby. She don't know it's your girl. And she jump on you and hug you up. I'm asking you, caller, should your moms cut and go home or go about our business? Talk fear, man. Talk fear. Not too biased.
Me don't know what nobody feels. Me know my one.
So may I ask you if the woman forgot her yard too?
He said, me don't know about fear and feeling. Me know about my one.
That me a talk about. Good answer. Real
don't
talk.
Don't worry yourself. Come and cut and go and left you too.
Yeah.
All right. So it got cut for cut.
A serious thing when me go yard.
And when you come out, you have serious things with me and you too. I'm sorry for you.
It's up to you.
All right. And it's up to you.
I want to know a big trouble that me and your God, a man will come home and embrace you. You're going to be mad, man.
So when me come home, when me come home, what you going to do? Tell me what you going to do when me come home.
I said termite to the house.
Eh?
Me not gonna hit you, but when you don't talk, maybe you think you feel better than it, yeah?
So what you gonna do? Me ask you.
What?
What you going to do?
You have to give me some good estimate.
You know what me going to do with you?
Yeah.
I tell you off ear.
All right, Madonna.
Me know. All right, Daddy.
Yeah, respect. You know, I tell them, I said, boy, a long time for the emerging link.
Yeah, a long time for true.
Believe it.
Pick up yourself.
I'm going to show you something straight up. I want all of the youth that listen to this. I'm not telling them straight up. Don't trust no link. On the ear, me say, don't trust no link because me admit it straight up. Me buck up sistrine a place already, right? Get a hug up. And I whisper in her ears, Jano, my girl, your body still feel good.
Jesus.
It all just look innocent and everything just seem dandy, just like a little normal thing, but it's a dangerous thing. Not trust here, nobody.
That picture there alone when my skin crawl. Hug up and whisper in her ears.
We don't know what I whisper. You don't even know say I whisper go on.
No, we can't see the move, the body language.
You can see body language.
The hug there, and you can't see the person tell you something in your ears. That here, when me go home, me and you,
I mean,
a war.
War, oh, about
physical
what?
War, too.
No, but it's all the. Hold on. Certain things you can't go with shake on. And that are the real catch, you know. Road boys, when you know this. Oi. Watch the moms, them, right? If they switch all them on and say them shake the man on, I sign that.
When
too.
I saw the first episode of the movie, the series called Power,
yeah.
And the wife fixed up herself nicely and gone to the club, gone to meet her husband.
Yeah.
And before she was carried or escorted to her husband, she was there rapping with some friends. And then she saw the husband heading down the stairs, face all elated, excited. And she thought he was heading to her to meet up with her and to greet her. Lo and behold.
I'm over that, man.
No. I read something. Lo and behold, he headed towards another woman. Hugged her nicely, nice squeeze. She stood there watching it all. And guess what? That was his high school sweetheart girlfriend from before him and she get married.
Yeah.
And they stood there for how long exchanging words and smiles and phone number and all these things. Yeah. What do I have though? Cut on her yard.
Then she don't know where she live.
And I can't tell you what happened after that. But anyways, for those who watched it, they know what happened after that.
Never
but Charm said, burn up, Cleo. Boom, is it boom or bun?
Bun up. Burn up.
Burn up, Cleo. Open Charm for me. First she says, talk true, Cleo. That's right, Cleo. Burn up. I guess is with the fact that the man, I don't know which part she's burning, but she's burning some part of that. Jackie in Canada say, yes, Cleo, cut for cut. Laugh out loud. R&B barbershop in the UK, because if anything in the dark must come to light one day to come.
Toronto, I say.
Toronto.
Rashik.
Okay. Rashik from Toronto said, Not trust no girl. I agree.
Hey, believe me. Hold on. At 10:30 already. Ladies and gentlemen, the time is brought to you by VJ Printing Services. It's now 10:30.
Stick and stay on
styles. We're sponsored by Bayview Eco Resort and Spa.
Stick and stay. We soon forward.
Architects, draftsmen and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VJ Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high quality white paper printing that is water resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
Babes, where are you over there, sir? Babes, where you really are you over there, sir, babes?
Me a look for the radio cause I saw schizophrenia with DJ Mookie. He have mad skills and crazy hype. And he's on this and every Tuesday and Wednesday from 1 p.m. to 5 p.m. No, me can't miss it. You mad?
Oh, what? The hour between 3 to 4 is sponsored by Rap Auto Supplies.
Bayview Eco Resort and Spa, boasting amenities such as restaurant, bar, spa, conference area and swimming pool, were perfect for a business trip or vacation. Make a reservation today by calling us at 993-3118 or email us at bayviewecoresortspa@gmail.com.
Bayview Eco Resort and Spa, a sponsor of Real Talk with Daddy Rude and Lady Cleo. Monday nights, 9 p.m. till 12 midnight.
Remember Styles FM on social media. View us on YouTube, Styles FM Radio. Follow us on Instagram at Styles FM. Like us on Twitter at Styles FM 961. Become a fan on Facebook. Styles FM 96.1.
Planning a party, club night out, stage show, a gospel concert, or even a business sales event? Let Styles FM be a part of your promoting tool. Take advantage of our low-priced promotion packages with commercials, interviews, giveaways, reviews, and much more. We have special offers when you mix and match and bundle your options. Contact us at 876-286-9216 or 439-5160. Styles FM for the most effective way to exploit your marketing dollar.
This is
writers say, well, they need to go too far or it make you uncomfortable or whatever. Because it certainly makes no sense. You go sit down and just say, oh, they are just friends. So that is just it or something. And then when you take a step, then you're hurt, you're in a pain. Because it say it could be more than just friends.
I really like this topic. I realize that the men really do spend a lot of time with their male friends. I notice at night they would hang out a lot, and I'm sure they all have girlfriends. Well, yes, I would have a problem with it, whether or not I met them like that. And not to nag him at all times, but there are times that he should be home, right? So if I'm going to hang out like night after night with a male friend, that would be a problem. And then I'll be there all alone. No, man. I think, yes, I would talk to him about it. And if we can't deal with it, then we just come out of it.
Well, my personal opinion, I don't think anybody should think that they have the right to tell someone what to do or how to live their life. So in my case, if I'm in that shoe, I don't believe that I have the right to tell my partner that his relationship with his friend or male, you know, his female friend is too close. No, what I think I can do is, you know, because at the end of the day, if you meet these people before you knew me, why should I have a problem with it, right? And if in the case I see that this friendship is too close, or there's something more than friendship, what I need to do as a person is sit down with my significant other and talk to them and let them know how I feel. No, if my significant other not do nothing about it, then I will have a right, and that's the right to walk away. But real talk, in a real life, real talk, I don't think anybody should feel like they have the right to tell somebody or to live them life. Because I don't feel like I'm supposed to have a right to tell me, say, me not to talk to my brethren them, and me know my brethren them before me know him. You understand what I mean? I say, it's up to me to learn to respect myself and to learn to respect my significant other to know how to behave accordingly. You understand what I mean? I say, so in a real life, real talk, nobody have the right to tell nobody how to live, but you can voice how you feel, speak your mind, and if you still continue to feel that way or see that the person has no respect for you and still behave that way with their friends, then you have a choice to walk away. You have a choice to hand them a pink slip and move on. Real talk.
Real talk.
All right, welcome back, guys. I think some of the callers, some of our respondents, missed it a little bit where they related to saying that your partner is expecting you not to talk to the person or have the person as a friend. But that's not where we're going with it. It's pretty much how close. Right. So you are allowed to have your friend in.
Man can't want
but on a serious note, closeness, right? Physical closeness, verbal closeness, what you talk about, the language you use, you know, with each other, to each other and so on. That's what we're talking about. How close should it be? And how close is really too close?
And let me ask a question. All right. In a situation where, say, people grow up together, mm-hmm. that one is kind of hard, you know, feed you.
Yeah, it's kind of right? sticky.
So you feel, say, your partner for falling and become friends with, you know?
Yeah, and then you have a different degree of closeness.
Start play ball together.
Yeah, because if you grow up with the person, you know.
Well, I'm talking, man.
Yes.
You start playing ball together, nooks, marble, and them something there. Mm. You feel so they start have that kind of little bridging and bridging link there. For make things work.
Still, the level of closeness of a monitor.
No, I talk, you have your bridging and where you and them link from when you grow up.
Yeah.
Right? Cook pot all of them something there. Your man, upon the scene now, would you feel better if them establish a kind of brethren link there?
But of course.
Right? As again, if you say, yo, you them can't cook pot again with them.
Yeah, no, man. Him try fit in.
And if anything, them can end out and go a bar or drink like how, Ray. You have to do that?
Once in a blue moon.
What, you have to do that?
Want to go find a woman game? And all these things. You never know.
No, but if brethren and brethren link, brethren and brethren have a link.
Man and man link different from woman and man link. That man want to try to tell you. And when we cover up and cover up and cover up for him, them now cover up so no, easy for me.
Let me tell you straight up. Big man thing. Me and you could have friend little more.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Group. You know, link. kill crab. I don't know, kill crab, I don't catch crab, anything.
Catch right? them, then kill them, then eat them.
And you get a man. You think me, I go tell pan your man.
You see me talk
straight
about?
Up, me nah do it. There's a code.
Nobody friend him then. Nobody friend him then. Make him stay and we cut you off with the pot story. Yeah, we're not cooking more pot. One boy your business. You know, ain't have my back.
Me nah talk.
If me you not, tell me where I'm going no, with, I'm a
no,
friend.
No. Of course, me a friend. But me nah talk.
If you talk.
I'm a brethren.
New kid from the block all of a sudden.
Hold on. Is either him fall in line or him in farmer, you know? That might make
him
know.
Stay in farmer.
No, him in farmer and wait.
Yes, that's the point.
No, you see? We have to encourage him to do certain things. So that's when he see we are doing certain things in
you know,
farmer.
You know what is true?
And he more come talk.
Yeah,
and
listen this.
He more come talk and tell you what we are doing. You go, go back to in farm.
Gracie.
Go tell my woman.
Now listen this. Don't matter friend my guy then. Please. Gracie says, me never like what she did after.
Mm-mm.
Let's go back to the open Gracie's messages there. Gracie says, Cleo, did you...
Oh, where talk about then, Gracie? You never like what you did after. What that? We don't pick up that part there.
Yeah, I didn't get that part at all. All right. Anybody else up there? Mm-hmm. Let's see. This is Cadian.
Yeah.
Wouldn't have a problem with it. It's all about trust. I have close friends. He has close friends too. Just so it go. Just bill.
Yeah.
Depends on how close they are. I'm sorry. I ain't billing on no too closeness. Uh-uh. I ain't billing. I'm sorry.
Me see.
Hold on a minute. Some females just want a man to bridge a gap.
Oh, that's the first part
from
I want to
Malcolm.
Talk about.
All right, Malcolm, thank you.
Yeah, bridge gap.
The text line.
One
and,
thing, one with a gap, you know.
What's Jackie in Canada saying? But Cleo, are the man... Okay, I think we read that one already. No? No, we didn't read it. But Cleo, are the man have to let her know herself? If him don't say anything about that, in my mind, something going on. And then me have to do some investigation for myself. No man, my friend, don't play. No man. My friend don't play with my man. Hell no. Me agree with Daddy Rude tonight. Yes, Cleo. Cut for cut.
I mean,
pretty
Jackie.
Much. Yeah.
So,
alrighty.
We're going to play the next Vox part because we have some sitting for run through. Because I say at 11 o'clock, people, me I tell you now, it will be a different sitting.
If I met my partner with a close friend, I don't think I should have the right to want to break their friendship apart. As long as I'm sure that it's just a normal friendship, I shouldn't want to get between them because I go and see them as a friend. That's unfair because I wouldn't want to have a friend and he come and see me with a male friend and then want to tear it apart. I may not believe in that. That's not real. What you don't want for yourself, don't give it to other people. Everybody have the right to make at least a decision. Everybody have to have a choice of having a good friend. At the end of the day, the relationship can mash up, and his friend is always going to be there. So I don't think I should have the right to make a decision that I want to mess up the friendship that I go and see him with. That's unfair.
Depends on the closeness of the relationship. Me and the person, me and my boyfriend, we're in a relationship and it come like a three person in a relationship. Every minute that person call you and open our business and all of that. So if it is so too personal, me go tell him, say, me no need that person in a relationship. And if it's a friend, it's a friend. Everybody's entitled to have a friend, but it depends on how deep that friendship is. Because if I'm here, there, me here, there, not me and you and the person there, or your friend there. So it depends on the type of relationship we're having and how close that person in there. And yes, I think I deserve to know about the other person. And we'll be very observant, and if I don't like something, I'm going to tell you, even if I go vex or argue or whatever, I'm going to let you know that I'm not comfortable with you and that person. And I'm not going to mandate that you're not supposed to talk to them, but you're not going to be that close with them. I mean, why you be that close with them either? For me, they're not me and you and them, they're simple as that.
Well, if you feel that way, I think you should express your feeling if you feel that they're too close to comfort and tell him why. Yeah, not because you met them that way. You're in the picture now, so things can't stay the same. It have to change up a bit. Because sometimes, you know, when you go with that woman's intuition and your gut feeling, you know, if something not go say it, go near so, that's just my take on the matter.
Yeah, they can be good friends, like, oh, you'd like to have a partner, a friend, but you would have and is your friend, nothing more than just your social friend. So I guess is his friend.
I think there should be boundaries now that the relationship has taken a different twist or turn. There's somebody else involved here to think about, so there should be boundaries.
I'll relax myself because I know there was friend before and they can be friends.
Yeah, Carla, what's going on?
Boy, me there, I just get lucky, you know, because I did that church.
Praise Jesus, brother.
I did that church, and video and play, then I'll walk the factory, so just I get lucky.
Where you learn at church today?
Boy, you know, so it's a nice little play. It's a nice little play, then they have a church, you know.
Boy, we start off a show with one church woman. I tell them, say, boy, is a real man. We mine a woman, a real man, buy a woman clothes, a real man, buy a woman house, and all kind of sitting. That the church woman, yeah. I tell the people in the church, say,
what to that church lady there, man?
There's something wrong.
Real woman then, do accept them.
The real woman pamper their men and treat them very nicely.
Which, so we don't know what we don't want them buy one house to her and buy one. Want something, buy one car.
That, we buy one clothes and food and shoes and them things there, yeah.
No, we can buy
a nice underpants. You're comfortable to keep something in
it. No, man, we can buy them there.
But we can buy clothes and house and shoes too and
so
car
so that one if you buy, we.
They say lucky now. Know.
Me come and see the concert. I want picture with you real quick. Me there. I
still
need
to
come down.
All right.
Cool.
Avid listener, can I tell you? Rushing home to get to this one. Hello, caller, good night.
954, Wagwan.
Wagwan, Medea. Wagwan, Rude. I'm me, Tero.
Wagwan, Terozang.
Medea. Listen, 25 years ago, I have a family member who she was friends with someone, real good friends, you know, the gentleman was married, and he was just like a brother to the family, the family member who was very sick, and so because he had transportation, he was always there to take her to the hospital whenever she needed to go there. So even if it's 2 o'clock at night and she had to go to the hospital, he was there. Now she got married when I was about 10 years old.
Mm-hmm.
And they were still close friends. I can't say that they were intimately involved because they weren't. But it was just that good relationship. I think nowadays, because men and women cheat so much on each other, we lose that extra connection that we should have with someone else.
Sure.
Mm-hmm.
And even after she divorced her husband, they remained close friends. And you know what broke up the relationship that she had with that external partner, that person.
What?
Only that my mother sent to him for him to take care of some family business. And he didn't do as he was told. That was what really set the relationship apart. And mind you, he was doing business for us for so many other years. But that one instant where he took that money and did his own business and didn't carry out what he wanted to do.
You violate
the relationship up. Yeah,
you violate, man. You can't ramp with people money. No matter what.
Eh?
You can't ramp with people money.
Exactly, you can't ramp with people money.
You can't do that. No matter what. You don't ramp with people money.
True.
Real talk. So what go on? You good?
Trust. Eh? You good? I'm a good man. Eh? And another thing. Say I talk about man. Must watch woman when woman a shake man hand cause that a code. What kind of code that? Eh?
Terror. And a time yet.
Look at no.
Mm-hmm.
I know what I mean. a shake can do it on pound to pound. I mean, I know what you are talking about. What you are talking about?
Terror.
Ask him again, Terror.
Terror. You know, my tell you the God Almighty truth. A long time you're not frightened. You frightened me a while ago, you know? You frightened me.
Terror. Yes. Terror, can I tell you how I like your transition? You were calm and subtle in the beginning.
Hey, but I'm frightened, you know.
By the time you reached down the road, I felt you were coming here to give him a fine ass a while ago. I swear.
Hey, may I tell you the truth? You see that short the way you short off of me a while ago? I want to then kill nature short there. I tell you the truth. If it uprising right now, the thing low.
Yes.
Tell her later, yeah, man. Because we know you soon call back for sitting else, you know.
Yes, man. It's hot on my mind, mate. It's on my mind. It's me, I forgot gym. I'm going to gym, I'm never going to spend my 2 hours at the gym. I have to come home. Because it's still, my blood a boil for that man.
Real talk. Real talk.
Real talk.
All right, photos.
All right, look more.
Yeah.
When you talk about avid listeners, you talk about avid listeners.
Make
like
a run, make a run in the last box up. Come on, make Cleo read if I even half of the article. Because she's going to like it still, straight up. She's going to like it.
Real talk.
All right, real talk, family. So the question tonight, this is my opinion. If me meet my partner and he has a close female friend, as long as the friendship, their friendship is not at a disrespectful rate to me, me coming in and friend lie down up in a bed with him or them something that, I have no problem. Because I know for a fact, myself, I have a lot of male friends. Not male friends where I lie down up in my bed, me and them daddy or anything like that. But I do have a lot of male friends. And I don't let my friendships get to the part where it's going to be disrespectful to my partner. So no, I wouldn't have a problem with my partner having a close female friend, as long as it's not crossing the border of friendship. As long as them keep it at friendship and not sexship, I mean, I have no problem.
So yes, them stop talk, them stop communicate as close as they were. I think they still communicate, but not on a regular basis as they used to. And the reason why me kind of regret it, is that it kind of seems unfair that I'm the one who came between them when they had such a close relationship. And then I have a friend who is close to me too. So it's like I have to drop that friend. Yeah, I have to drop that friend in order to be fair, since I was the one who let him drop his best friend.
I believe there are things that need to be changed once you're committed into a relationship. Things can't always stay the same. That's why there's change for improvement. There's change for different scenarios. And yes, I believe if they already met like that and they've been friends and very close in that way, you know, it needs to change, because if now we're in a relationship, what matters more, the relationship or the friendship? So sometimes you got to put certain limits and standards to things in life.
Wow.
Real talk. And can I
tell
you, I love the second to last one. Stay a friendship and not go over in a sex ship. Yes.
Bad.
I'm good with that.
I get a WhatsApp and I never even did remember this one. The shake and thing. You know, shake somebody and then tickle your hand, Miguel.
Mm-hmm.
Dangerous stuff. That's why I'm saying, I trust a shake and business. Can't see the laugh. You never think about it. Can't see, unless you never remember that one there. And somebody WhatsApp it to me. Yeah, man, you can't shake. You know the shake and the tickle.
You're
and
sending her a message, right? So you know whatever caller on this line.
No, but you know. But you as a
four,
person,
five,
don't know what I go on.
Hello, caller. Good night.
You. You know, if you can shake and you can't pass, and you have phone number too.
And the tickling the hand, Miguel.
And today, now, Carla, you come call back now about pass and phone number. Mm-hmm. But your girl can't. Your girl can't get no up, but you can't pass on about, you know, your hand, Miguel. Mm-hmm.
Then you write it, man, and the shake and pass on the number, man.
It's all right. It's all right.
Can't trust
You're too biased.
Can't trust a shake hand business.
Mr. St. Thomas, you're too biased.
No, touch him. Let me do it. I told you I'm going to send him. Go with
you, sir. All right, my
darling. I'm not going to need you to come here. I said, go with you, sir. We're going together.
I'm company you're looking. You go on.
Go on. All right. We have a read while sitting here now, here.
Oh boy, my
man, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for participating with the Vox Pop and all of the people and with the pandemic cruise and take the time out for send your Vox Pop. Give thanks, enough respect.
And those who were at the gym and ran home, big up yourself. And those who were rushing after the church play, big up on yourself.
Big up on yourself.
All right, cool. All right, so the article is entitled 7 things that women will always be attracted to. Men, I hope my brothers are all listening right now, y'all.
And this article was done in 2004.
Teen by Jordan Gray. Right? And I think it's a female. Jordan?
I don't know yet.
Possibly. So, men, these 7 things women will always be attracted to.
Rubbish.
All right, gentlemen? So, here we go.
Rubbish.
If there's one thing that I've learned in my career as a relationship coach is that guys' beliefs about what actually attracts women is pretty backwards. Men have been raised with the false belief that they should always appear detached, cool, and unemotional 24/7, or risk being known in a guy world as weak. So in other words, men, when you're detached from your emotions, yeah, or you're playing so cool, calm, and collected all the time, nothing fears you, nothing bother you, you don't have no emotions about nothing, we don't think it's cool. I swear, we don't. Because it shows how next to inhumane you are. Mm-hmm. It's real talk. Continuing with the article. I've encountered countless driven entrepreneurs who work tirelessly for years to amass their fortune, only to find that the wall of cash that they've built around themselves is only making it more difficult for them to find a woman who values them for their character. True. So all the money them have in the world cannot help them to find a woman who will treasure them for their character. Because sometimes they really don't have any.
Somebody tells them we'll not give them no money.
I've had potential clients be on the fence about whether to spend some of their cherished time and money doing their internal work. But they don't hesitate to buy a flashy watch or car, presumably for the same end goal of trying to attract a high-quality woman in their lives. Face palm.
And it work.
So they use the flashy stuff.
And it work.
Sad to say, the flashy cars will attract a woman as opposed to a man's quality of character. So you could be an old dog, but once you have a flashy car, you're good with it? Mm-mm. Can't be okay. Well, I guess to each his own, whatever you prioritize, that's going to be the thing, right? So, if cash flowing, fancy accessories, and an inexpensive face don't attract high quality, loving women, which they really don't, then what character traits are women attracted to? Here are 7 of the most important things that women will always, and I say always, be attracted to. Mark you, there are exceptions to every rule because there are some women who will be attracted to the cash flow, cha-ching-ching, ching, and some who will love the fancy watch, the fancy clothes, the bashment, expensive double-figure boots, and all these things. Yep, they will want that, some of them, but there are others who want these 7 things. Be conscious of a few of these in your daily life and you'll save yourself time, money, frustration, and headaches in trying to deeply engage your dream woman on an emotional level.
Dream woman.
Yes. 7 things that women will always be attracted to. And I trust the men. The men are listening. So number one, drive. And I don't think it means your car. Okay? I'm really attracted to a guy who knows what he wants in life and is going after it. I absolutely adore being around that kind of energy, Jessica, who's 27, says. Women are attracted to men that have goals and are actively pursuing them. In other words, Daddy Road, listeners, a woman will not be attracted to a kinaki boy pandekana who have young, energetic, vibrant, talented, you know. Well, guess what? The old worthless boy now do nothing with him time and energy and talent. All him doing is just digging out him and mingle every day. A bone spliff.
No work.
But Sarah pass in her pike heel boot and decides, oh, she a nurse. She a teacher.
No,
she a lawyer. I'm going to look after him.
It happens. But you can't say they go and talk because I'm sure them youth they still a get girl. So no matter what you talk, every woman have them tick a bush. That may make you know.
Another statement if you use right there, so. Some people are just idiot.
No.
Masculine.
I go on read. Go
masculine
on read.
Energy is directional energy. Like a boulder rolling down a hill, the single focus energy that penetrates through resistance in pursuit of achieving an end result is very attractive to women. To sensible women. Because the one who go for the men with just the money and the fancy stuff, those men are normally such great egotists that they really don't even value you as a woman. They really don't. Because they can get any girl, enough girl in a bungle and all these things, trailer load.
Of course.
So to them, you are just another statistics, if you ask me.
Not really.
In some cases, most instances, they are.
She plays her part, but it's now 11 o'clock. We're going to a break. We'll soon follow. The time is brought to you by VJ Printing Services.
Stick and stay.
Architects, draftsmen, and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high-quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for a presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VJ Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer-aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high-quality white paper printing that is water-resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
This feeling is taking over me. I'm so excited.
What? Feel the euphoria.
Tuesdays from 5 to 9 p.m. with the master mixer musical maestro digital team.
Giving a total satisfaction with melodies and memories by the score. With the widest selection of genres and hits. So you don't know the program you turn up, you know. So you know politics are full dance. The one that one you slap with.
Digital and we are party. Yeah, we flawless. Euphoria the program. Every Tuesday.
5 to 9. Every Tuesday.
With the musical maestro digital team.
Good morning, Heavenly Father.
5 a.m. The Lord's Hour on Styles FM 96.1 and 96.7. Tune in to be blessed and inspired by the Word of God and uplifting gospel music. Start your day right. Start it with the Lord's Hour.
Have or are you seeking a place to rent, seeking employment or have a job vacancy? Are you selling a car or having a garage sale? Then come see us. Let Styles do the advertising for you and you'll be on your way in no time. Contact us at 876-286-9216 or 439-5160. Advertising Style. Advertise with Styles.
Bayview Eco Resort and Spa. Boasting amenities such as restaurant, bar, spa, conference area, and swimming pool, we're perfect for a business trip or vacation. Make a reservation today by calling us at 993-3118 or email us at bayviewecoresortspa@gmail.com. Bayview Eco Resort and Spa, a sponsor of Real Talk with Daddy Rude and Lady Cleo. Monday nights, 9 p.m. till 12 midnight.
Welcome back, guys. And I'm doing the article about the seven things that a woman will always be attracted to. And of course, the first one was the drive of a man, the man who has his head screwed on and has an ambition and where he wants, knows where he wants to go, and he's going for his goals and pursuing them, right? So we continue with that one. But drive, they say, she says, isn't always enough on its own. Ideally, you'll be driven in something that you're passionate about. High-quality women, like myself, are definitely more attracted to a man who is dripping with passion about his work as an artist, despite making under $30,000 a year, compared to a man who reluctantly went into law to please his parents and is so unenthusiastic about his work that he uses less self-deprecating and dismissive language every time you try and talk to him about it. As much as most men resist this idea, when it comes to attracting a high-value woman, like myself, of character, drive beats dollars every time. So, yes, I would prefer a man who's an artist and he loves it, he has a passion for it, and he enjoys doing it so much, as opposed to one who, okay, he was shoved into law school because his parents say, hey, go do law. And every time he has to talk or mention anything about law, it's just pure profanity and disgust and disdain you hear coming out of his mouth. Yes, that would annoy any woman and frustrate any woman.
I use a lot of profanity.
And let me just say, by the way, for you men out there who think that it's just work, work, work and earn the dollars all the way, and you're not trying to build a family in either, uno I got end up all angry with no shrivel up grananas, we can't function, and I have nobody and no picking around uno because uno never take time out to make a family and support one and love one. Real talk.
If not interject.
Number two. Presents. I'm meant to tell you about presents. Massa.
And them not talk about things, you know.
Boy. Have you ever seen some men on the street? Them just look pop down and mash up like the, it's like a grenade just explode upon them. Seriously? Jesus. Not to mention the smell. Men, ladies love when a man smell like him can't eat. Yes. Yes, Cassidy, I'll repeat it. A woman loves when a man smell like him can't eat up. Glob, glob.
All the ladies.
Yes.
All the ladies who agree, do. Send a message by the box, by the WhatsApp.
When you pass him and you smell him, you say, Jesus. One man can't smell so good. He must twin. Yes. So presents, ladies. Gentlemen, please turn up your radios. Every person wants to feel deeply seen and understood by someone in their lives. That's a real talk. But few people want to take the time out to explain or reveal themselves. When it comes to deeply connecting with a woman on an emotional level, your presence will always mean more than any presence ever could. So your presence, how you appear and how you are there, without any physical gift wrap of something, right? By being fully present with women through eye contact, listening to them, prioritizing, distraction-free conversations. She can't be talking to you and you're on the phone texting away like crazy. Online, I look on Kiar, our pretty girl on your phone, and the woman I try to talk to you and reach out to you.
You can't want man get a pic, just get a pic and you want to talk to
you. Give them the sense of feeling seen.
Hold on, Cleo. Man, I beg you a pic all the while and you send on a pic. And you try to talk about this and try to talk about that, and man just get a pic, and if you put on your phone and listen to you.
Of course.
Nah, man, the pick important, man.
Jesus.
Very important.
Listeners, ladies, are you seeing what I'm talking about? Okay. No, let's move on, because I don't want to cuff you tonight.
You know what I'm saying?
Everyone, male or female, wants to feel deeply seen and appreciated. And nobody like, ladies, nobody like the men. When they're going through them little six stage or them little frustration period, they want you as the woman to be there for them, be listening to them, being empathetic, being sympathetic. Our name now go through nothing really, you know. One little flu, one little fever, them turn newborn baby on you. And they want you to be there and supportive of them. And they want your presence to be seen and to be felt. But guess what? Them no one give it to you in return.
But all
selfish crops, some of them.
We're a doctor. We're a nurse.
Yeah, male nurses. Moving right along.
One up.
Want a less...
Hold on. I know about three of that.
No. Oh. Want a less new agey term than presence? Attention. Give your woman attention. It's very important. What percentage of your attention are you giving the woman you're speaking to moment to moment? Is the answer anything but 100%? Then you aren't being fully present or attentive with her. Turn off the TV, for God's sake. Put it on mute then, no? If you can't turn it off, and probably if you want to cock your eye a little bit down again, but Lord, make her say I listen to her. Put down the cell phone. Face her directly. Give direct eye contact. Just look for me, look at me eye. I talk to you. Cover your phone. See me talk about? And truly hear the words that she is telling you. That kind of laser beam focus of attention makes women weak in the knees. That's right. Look at me. You see me, I get weak right now. I tremble. Thank you, Cassidy. That's it.
Ladies and gentlemen,
we need these things. Attention, and we need... What's the first one again?
Presence is
presence,
the first one.
No, it's the second one. And drive. I love this article. Jesus. So
we're gonna,
number three short.
No, we're going to continue with it. Based off of what we're going, we need to continue with this next week.
Number three so short. Okay, number three, no, please. No. Oh, this is very short.
No, man. Make me do
He's not listening to me right now. He's not looking to my eyes and listening to my request. That's not nice.
This I talk about us.
It's
look,
not nice.
Look, all this I talk about us are looking for funky, man. Right? We're not the fun, we're this the fun. So... Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to continue with this next week.
Girls just want to have fun.
So we have so we have five more to read. It's kind of a bit torturing, but last week, we had our time last week. So I'm this is a gift from us to you ladies.
Whatever.
So Cassidy, bring up the topic for tonight.
The longer the better.
Yeah.
Ladies, next week I'll share the other five with y'all, okay?
Yes, we'll definitely do it earlier.
The men are happy now, I'm sure, but too bad. Next week you're going to hear it all. All right, so tonight, dear Real Talk.
Yeah, man, this article, I love it.
Mm-hmm, that you love. I listened to your show last week, and I have a similar situation dealing with.
Yeah?
I've been living overseas for some 30 years now.
Yeah.
But I make an effort to visit yaad every 3 years, sometimes twice in a year.
Good
for business, leisure, of course, and pleasure.
Yeah.
Real talk. As a foreigner, I try not to get into anything serious because most women only see the remittance opportunity.
Real talk.
That's a real talk. I hooked up with this sistrine on one of my trips, and there was an instant connection. But after I left, that was it for me. Old cruff. So me talk about? So me talk about? Attention, not dear.
At least he's honest.
Just for the sex.
At least he's honest.
Yeah, kind of inconscience, I kill him. Some years later, I saw her, but oddly, she didn't look so hot.
Mm-mm.
Real talk.
Real talk.
It seems things weren't so prosperous with her, and I instantly developed a soft spot for her, real talk. I'm sorry, fair enough.
Yeah, man.
To be honest, she didn't seem to really remember me that much. But during our conversation, she said she had dropped out of college because she had gotten pregnant some 13 years ago and her boyfriend left her.
Not a boy.
Oy. When she decided not to do an abortion and the whole thing took a toll on her. So she had the baby. She decided not to have an abortion, so she had a child.
And the boy left her.
And things just went downhill for her, pretty much.
Pretty much.
Daddy Rude, my heart sink when I saw her daughter. Sweet and innocent. Me no know how the muma no sissy and me are the pupa. I know what happened on the night we had sex.
Yeah.
Obviously, she didn't.
Knocked out.
Him just knock a works. Knock a works, see it, because him get some.
And splurt.
She now decided to give it up because she have feelings and some level of attachment for this guy.
Yeah, I get too deep, man.
Really, no, yeah, that's not my youth.
About. See what we talk about earlier in the show.
See that happened, Mr. Mayo.
No.
Why then didn't she decide to, you know
then
what?
Then oh, should I remember
give
him?
Up this child.
Oh, should I remember him? Oh, should I remember him?
Poor girl, if she in love with the man.
Distraught. Oh. Oh, should I remember him?
Then wouldn't remember him neither.
You know what?
If him get my parents and gone left him in love, I wouldn't remember him either.
No, but read out.
Move on.
Read
out. We're reading on. Yeah. So I want... Wait, where am I?
Okay. I get too deep in that.
I know what happened on the night we had sex. You used her and left her, yes. Obviously, she didn't. She wanted a relationship and you didn't give it to her, yes. I'm back in the States and I really want to reach out to her. I want to take care of her and send her back to school, etc. 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 I have a whole lot of different meaning right to say, you know.
Anyways, a whole lot of things for you, man.
I'm still married to the lady that got me my papers and, of course, he's still with their kids. Opportunist.
Why
and as far as she is concerned, I don't give trouble.
None at all. Man, a good man.
Laugh out so loud.
Man,
she's
a good
so
man.
Naive, poor woman.
Why you say that?
How am I going to sort this out? Coming to yard soon, and I want to take some things for them both. So, pretty much, ladies and gentlemen, this guy, living overseas for a while, he visits Jamaica once or twice or even three times per year. When he comes here, he does his business. He finds time to leisure, relax on the beach, but he also finds time to pleasure and go get some nookie. Yeah? So he met this chick, and of course, being a foreigner, you know, that girl might be all over him at times, jumping up on him, and yeah, all of that, having parties and so on. So he met this chick, who he considered a one-night stand, yeah?
Amen.
Wanted to mash some works, got with her sexually. She had other intentions, clearly. Then, he mashed the works, and that was it for him. He left. Lo and behold, he saw her years later.
And she look
this
so
poor
well.
Chick never looks so hot anymore.
No.
But he recognized her. And for some reason, she didn't. I don't know if it's fortunate or unfortunate. But she didn't recognize him. Lo and behold, he discovered that she had gotten pregnant some years back. Clearly from their encounter. And she dropped out of school because life took a whole different turn.
Because
for
our boyfriend at the time left her.
Are you serious?
No, that she say? Our boyfriend at the time left her because she decided that she don't want to dash for the picnic.
She had gotten pregnant some 13 years ago and her boyfriend left her.
Yeah.
Because he discovered that she was pregnant for some other man and didn't want to throw it away.
Yeah, add on funny thing. The man discovers that she had breed and he don't want her to have a picnic. So he cut.
So whether it's his or otherwise, he cut.
Yeah.
All right. So him cut and leave her and she popped down. Pretty much popped down after that. Hey, caller. All right, let's...
Yeah, Carla.
Hello.
Hi.
Good night. Welcome to the show.
Hello, good night.
Go right ahead, Carla. We're listening.
Hello. Yeah.
Oh, you're listening to me?
Oh, yes, you're on air, darling.
Ready. I tarot this, you know, I'm ready.
So you mean to tell me, so the man, they are the United States 30 years now, and he go back every 3 years.
Yeah.
And sometimes twice a year, right?
Yes, yes.
So that's an estimated 20 kids impossibly could have.
That's right, sister. That's right.
That's approximately 20 kids him could have fathered.
Yeah.
Possibly.
So just find out, say my father. Hold on, let me down. Come in hot for him.
Yes.
Find out, say him father one. Because him, God have it that him run into this woman.
Yes.
God must have said she really a try with this fitness for 13 years, right?
Oh, yes.
So imagine they had a 19 when possibly could have father and him not know about them 19 there.
Mm-hmm.
About that, listeners. And him condescending to with him all trifling self.
Yes.
But he's a foreigner. And he
yes.
When he goes back, he doesn't get into anything serious.
None at all.
Women only see.
None at all.
Opportunities. When feel like when him they go down there with him all tired granana because him can't meet the wife up at the man. Him go down there go sex off people, college pickiny, trick them up with him bag of lies and tell them about oh him a go come back. He come now go on like him righteous. Him not righteous.
Right, sister.
Ask your worthless, careless granana man.
That's it, sister. Walking around flinging himself here, there, and everywhere.
No, hold on. Then you see the man I try to make good. Or the man for walkless.
He's flinging himself. Him go down there twice a year. Got too much people pick girl picking where they have college.
Yes.
Him are the crap girl them where could have the fire in her life. Him hold them back with him all walkless thing.
That's right, sister.
Like say, think him as some. I'm a godsend. I'm a damn godsend. I'm a worthless man. I wish he would have called in tonight and defend himself.
Yeah,
I'm damn nasty. And people for start burn out them nastiness here. Because of them same foreign man here, when them come and can't come shake $2 fine, they have to box shit out of her mouth. I'm going to breed up people, girl picking them, make them drop out of school, call them a bring you. And them nothing say them fair about it. And carry picking it. Enough years. 18 to life, woman, they're Jamaica raised picking it by their own. And then come up here, I walk around with two pieces of gold chain. Have you pay a monthly installment pan it so that when them go to Jamaica, them can't look like same thing. And then go down there, breed up people, girl picking it. And come now with them right, self-righteous self.
True, sister.
I see this man, you see?
Real talk.
Wait, sir. Where's the man say, boy, she not look... She
about say, most woman at see,
remittance.
See this as remittance operative. What? Make me down before no interrupting them. I'm hot for him. So I have possibly 19 picking out the way I don't know about. And then I'm going to talk about said, and this part hot me for him even woo. More. I'm going to talk about said, she don't look so prosperous now. How she feel look prosperous? At 13 years old, woman I carry the picking if I, you know. 13 years she want. And the poor woman don't finish her college degree yet. Steve not bringing $2 for support herself and fitness. So she no must not look prosperous. In can't help, you know, I shake $2 in her pocket like him or anybody. And I come chat about God. If you clear off, him nasty.
So let me ask a question now, Terrazang. What if you do right now? You think, what can he do right now for the youth and for the mother?
But if no matter when he do, him know what he's supposed to do. He's not supposed to call in a couple. I come talk like in a God sent him, and I'm striking God sent him to fix up the thing.
The
and
devil.
He messed up the thing. The girl picnic could have done her college and dep on her advancement right there. No, he messed up the woman people picking it. And then I come talk like same in my anybody. Me not nobody.
So hold on, let me ask you a question. What about the boyfriend which she have at the time we left her? What am to him?
Boyfriend left her. I don't know. At this.
You know, I read it something good.
And this man got on the fool of people picking it. Eh?
You know, I read something good. She'd have a man at the time, but hold on.
Got a fool of people picking it, boss.
Then you know, hold on. Then hold on a little bit.
Eh?
You know, she said, I want a little. Listen, now let me tell you, take care of you. She give her something to a different man, a foreign
talk
man. She gonna give her something.
No.
And the young boy run him.
No.
And go down there.
She give her sitting. She read the answer green money.
No. Me, I'm going to put the blame on him now.
One night.
I'm going down there with him like a... Hold on. This man go down there with him like a tired granana. I'm going to trick up the people them y'all picking it.
Oh, him can't do this fear. You know where the road go. Him can't do this fear. When him go back to the States, him go find somebody fear. Him go bring her up. Him
yes.
Him go down there with that, you know. And then them go down there go cool up people college picking it with, you know.
But if it
go down there go do, you know.
Then if it a work, what him fi do?
Him can bring her to the land of opportunity, don't it?
13 years ago. And him come go and like say she have somebody else with him. And if you know say she have somebody else with you, make her wear a condom tonight.
Exactly.
How can I wear a condom tonight?
In a bus?
Bus what? Oh. Happy nights.
Him know what say him know what happened that night. But him, she don't know what happened.
Him use her.
Because him trick the girl.
Yes. Him trick her and left her. And tell her stories to all her.
But hold on. Right now, you know, a forgiveness him wanna seek, you know.
And I come talk about like him some damn righteous son of a wretch. Him is a nasty granada man.
Real talk.
You know, we talk about him married and him wife think him not get trouble. Him wife not think him get trouble.
He's a snake.
Man on the top swear for the husband and husband top swear for the wife them.
He's a snake.
So hold on. All right, what about the party? I want to take care of her.
STD and STIs can't get rid of.
Hold on, Tara.
Nasty behavior, yeah. Him nasty.
But Tara, is it must wash off by this man? Tara, the part where him said, I want to take care of her, send her back to school, etc. Him want to do that for her.
No business to call radio station and ask opinions on that. The man must know himself and go handle him business like a responsible man. Him not responsible. I know him not. Him not responsible, you know.
Yeah, man. The man said him heart drop. Him heart full up. Eh? Then you see, yeah, the man said, boy, heart sink. When you see Pitney, can't believe the woman doesn't see a feeling Pitney that.
Yet, him better, him heart not sink yet. Wait till him go up upper heaven gates. They have the answer to Peter and Paul.
Wait, you go too far, man. When we reach a bridge, we cross it. You go too far now. You go too. Wait, no, man. We have a good time, man.
We not wait. We're not waiting to reach no bridge.
Don't drink no water.
While in there, I'm fumbling business. In no business, they call and ask nobody from radio station.
Read
that. Them things. In most of the youth of him, if you just go down the handling business and stop him about him walk and carry some stuff. Imagine on the Santa Claus.
Oh my goodness. Thank you, darling.
Putos.
Tony, it's hot for him. It's hot for him.
Yes.
I wish him would have called him this evening himself.
Look at her. Very few times I'm actually speechless.
Tara, can I tell you? You gave it to him for me tonight, darling. Oh boy, she gave it to him for me tonight.
Yo,
I don't have to say another word.
My cheekbone hurt me. What minute I make her go and read it? I tell you. I love that. We can't go read about this.
She was so excited. And this caller now going to take her on, I'm sure. Hey, caller.
Down the road.
Yo.
If that man wants to start close, then that wouldn't reach her.
Aye! Bup!
No.
Wait, sir, if she had a close spin, worry. Hey, that man's a road boy. Me feel if you are still, you know. But in my view, she was irresponsible.
Hold on there, caller.
She was irresponsible.
Caller?
Me may I talk to you?
You on my show, so me I talk to you. Now you hear me now. You're gonna tell me that every woman who ever gets pregnant is a close pin?
No, not to myself.
I'm asking you a question. Daddy
no,
will be quiet.
Not to myself.
Daddy Rude, be quiet. When you call this show, you're talking to me and Daddy Rude. So you're telling me that every woman that you ever have a child with was a close pin?
No, sir.
You're too out of Adam Bright.
A different sort we're talking about. Different sort we're talking about.
Right, call if you call it open close spin.
Later, yeah, sir. We'll soon reach the break. We'll get the next call. Nobody appears she in mind.
Out of Adam Bright. Oh, good night. Woman a close spin.
I know that man, sir. Good night.
Uh-huh.
How it is?
Call her good night.
A charm this?
Yeah, man, I'm me again.
All right, put us. What I go on?
Listen. Yes, he may be wrong, but at least he
he might, yes, she can write, yes, so he might have holy packets, because a lot of these men, yes, they left up here and a good home, they go trick the girl, them, because the girl, them, stupid, big actually, they see the green dollars, them, I run for it.
Mm-hmm.
But him now have to correct it, yes, but in a sense, he went to correct it a long time, because he knows he went to sleep with the girl, that it is so bad that the girl not even remember him, and he remember her. And now, he might go want to think. He not should have think, he should have talked to her right then and there, say, boy, may you went sleep a couple of years or whatever, and then, Mr. the kid, make me do a DNA then for real, prove if the kid is mine, or whatever. And then take up the responsibility from this one.
But is he call her?
But then he might think and I have second thought, oh, he want for this and he want for that. Talk to her right there and then, because you're going to see the situation.
Call her?
When don't you mess it up?
But Charm.
Charm, can I tell you him thinking my one big shot for true? He thinks he's a big shot and he's not God's gift to women. That's the problem.
Big, yes, but yes, he's a big shot, yes. So he might go down there every year, go having.
Yes.
Right.
Having pleasure and him leisure. And I tell who him to tell our kind of story. Now, do you agree, Charm? And let us look at it from this perspective, that this young girl, some of them, I agree, you know, might be into men because they have the money and they're excited about the money. But he could have very well told this young girl some stories, too, to make her believe that he is interested in her and in a relationship.
Yes, they look their little children because they can tell them stories and a little pick me them bite.
Yes.
And I look no big woman when I buy this story them. Them I look little pick me them when they tell them story where they will frighten them and get them in a bed.
But after when a fool, when a fool, on the one, the whole library.
And that's what I'm saying. When he's going to say that she wasn't a clothespin, no, he's wrong to say that. Because guess what now? This poor girl must have been given some information as to believe that he could be so interested in her in having a relationship.
No doubt
he was not married at the time. He wasn't married at the time. And he told her stories, Daddy Rude, because he did he said he knew what happened that night and she doesn't. No order.
On a point of order.
She knows she doesn't know what happened that night, Charm, but he does. What is that suggesting?
That's right.
What is that suggesting, Daddy Rude?
Charm.
What is that suggesting? Well, Come on.
Charm. I don't know if you want old, but we are going to the 11:30 break. Are you want call back? All right. We are going to the 11:30 break. The time is now. The time is brought to you by VJ Printing Services.
Is that telling me something?
Architects, draftsmen and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high-quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VJ Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer-aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high-quality white paper printing that is water-resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
Portlanders, Akan Auto Technology, located at 33 Bomber Crescent, Port Antonio. Visit us for all your auto repair and servicing. We offer computerized wheel alignment, computerized wheel balancing, suspension checks, AC repair, inspection, and all your auto repair needs. For complete auto repair and service, visit or call Akan Auto Technology today at 715-5205. And remember, we are located at 33 Bonbrook Crescent.
Be wowed on Wow Factor. Mondays and Tuesdays, 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. It's informative, educating, and entertaining.
Wow! I feel good.
Put the joy of entertainment in your ears. Be a part of the Wow Factor on Styles FM.
Bayview Eco Resort and Spa, boasting amenities such as restaurant, bar, spa, conference area, and swimming pool, were perfect for a business trip or vacation. Make a reservation today by calling us at 993-3118 or email us at bayviewecoresortspa@gmail.com. Bayview Eco Resort and Spa, a sponsor of Real Talk with Daddy Rude and Lady Cleo. Monday nights, 9 p.m. till 12 midnight.
Planning a party, club night out, stage show, a gospel concert, or even a business sales event? Let Styles FM be a part of your promoting tool. Take advantage of our low-priced promotion packages with commercials, interviews, giveaways, reviews, and much more. We have special offers when you mix and match and bundle your options. Contact us at 876-286-9216 or 439-5160. Styles FM for the most effective way to exploit your marketing dollar.
Yeah.
Welcome back. Real Talk is here.
You are going to bring up the topic because I feel so clear as deliberately.
Deliberately what?
I send the wrong.
No, I'm going to read it again for the party again.
No. Here's what I would like. Because I said Drake text scene and some boy look like he missed something. Read over the whole thing.
No problem.
Do me, I beg you.
Dear Real Talk.
And hold on. And when you read it, I just want you to read it straight.
You're not
going to
read it, man.
Yeah, because you have a way where you twist up a thing, you know.
No.
Yeah.
Me have my interpretation. I'm in a fool to this.
And I don't want to paraphrase either.
Dear Real Talk, I listened to your show last week and I have a similar situation dealing with. I've been living overseas for some 30 years now, but I make an effort to visit Yaad every 3 years, sometimes twice a year, for business, leisure, and of course, pleasure.
Yeah.
Real Talk. As a foreigner, I try not to get into anything serious because most women only see the remittance opportunity.
Real talk.
I hooked up with this sistrine on one of my trips and there was an instant connection.
Yeah.
Instant connection.
Yeah.
But after I left, that was it for me.
Simple.
That was it for me.
Simple.
Some years later, I saw her, but oddly, she didn't look so hot.
Non-tab.
It seems things wasn't so prosperous with her, and I instantly developed a soft spot for her.
Mm-mm.
To be honest, she didn't seem to really remember me that much. But during our conversation, she said she had dropped out of college because she had gotten pregnant some 13 years ago, and her boyfriend left her.
Yeah.
When she decided not to do an abortion and the whole thing took a toll on her. Daddy Rude, my heart sink when I saw her daughter, sweet and innocent. Me no know how the muma, not to say I'm the pupa. I know what happened on the night we had sex. Obviously, she didn't. I'm back in the States and I really want to reach out to her. I want to take care of her, send her back to school, etc. I'm still married to the lady that I got my children with and the one I got my papers with. Wait, the one he had his papers, got his papers.
Good night.
With.
Yeah.
And as far as she is concerned, I don't give trouble. How am I going to sort this out? Coming to Yaad soon, and I want to take some things for them both.
Good night, Carla. Carla gone. All right, hear me, I said, Cleo. In my view, and St. Thomas, may agree with you. What them now look funny now? You see, if there was this love thing where Cleo talked about, obviously it never mean nothing to her. The night need to make sure to remember the man.
Don't tell me rubbish on my ears.
Hold on there.
That is rubbish on me attack on my ears, Daddy Rude.
Yo.
Good night, Daddy Rude and Leo Katcho.
Oh,
whoa. What's going on,
darling?
Hey, you know, sir, a man there have a guilt. A guilt when him said the baby, the girl look like him daughter.
Yeah.
Yeah, if you just take up that responsibility, if you just tell the girl that and reason the girl on that part. But you see, sometimes women have a guilt what they carry, no? And sometimes women have a beating what we get from God by certain things.
Yeah.
I mean, if I tell you.
So right now, that man get a beating from God. So, and he still, have a still get a beating.
So what do you know?
You see, here I know. You see, kids are part of life using them backgrounds. And call it a pension further down where you take care of your kids. See?
Yeah.
When a man don't get a child and a man just live. Might be when he's young and strong, everything is all right.
But one too when insect don't need a help.
Yeah.
I need somebody around him when he can't call. Right?
True.
If I even if call and say, Daddy morning, or Daddy how you do, and he's all right, you feel much better. Missing enough man there right now.
Oh, sorry, madam. Look like it.
We lost the caller. If you can call back.
But here we go now, Zain. And him right. But what may I look pan? Me feel say she knows that it was just a hookup.
What makes you say that?
You are getting the impression, say boy, she gets some argument and fall in love. The man I say, from him meet the thing, a connection go on, boom, him beat it, and him cut. Seeing? She obviously no member him really, cause it was nothing to she neither.
You cannot say that, Daddy. No, Rudy. It's been obvious. 13 years.
Come on, man. Right? And our
they
college
had no
man,
long-term relationship well, at the time, so she had forgotten him. It's possible.
It couldn't have been a relationship when she have our college man, right? A breach, she got breached by the college man. That go on.
Hello, caller. Good night. Hello, caller. You're on air.
Yes, good night. I tell this again.
Yes.
You well, they are talk about said the girl not have a connection. Obviously, there was some connection because the man said him meet the sistrine and instant connection. There was something going on with them. I trick the people, them gal Pitney when she there at school. And she believe him. I know she get the Pitney. And she did it with a broken heart. I take care of this because this man full up her head and said, oh,
No. You have it all wrong.
Him did it. Oh, yes, honey. Yeah. I'm going to come back
no,
down.
No, you have it all wrong.
He gave her some talk. Yes,
no,
he did.
You have it all wrong.
I should not hear a ding from him.
No, you have it all wrong. Because the thing stayed clearly.
No,
it stayed clearly, you know. Una try put on a thing.
I know what happened the night we had sex. I know what happened that night.
So
obviously
yeah,
she didn't.
Right.
What is that telling you, Daddy Road?
Obviously is either one they didn't
read
have.
Well, between the lines,
well,
man.
Is only one of two things. That is either they didn't have they had unprotected sex, or.
No.
Or the condom broke.
You can live a little more decent. The poor girl don't remember him.
No.
That's because he never mean nothing to her.
Caller, don't say that, Daddy Road. Caller, listen to me now. Let me ask you a question.
What you mean he don't mean nothing to her?
Then woman, I forgot no man.
Oh, you mean?
Woman, nah, I forgot no man.
If it is that
you
this man.
Are you the same one, sir?
Hey.
When, hold on, Terror.
Please.
Terror, you don't listen to the show when it just start. No, Cleo, same one, sir. When me, I say, woman, take things from man and I run nothing. And once I run something, then feel so you and them there. Right? If this did mean something to the woman, once she run the something on the man, she would never forget him for the rest of his life.
Dad, caller, if it is that this woman got information led her to believe that. Let me talk, as a matter of fact,
she wouldn't have fees.
Daddy Rude.
She wouldn't have fees. Is our college man that will get her
Daddy
pregnant?
Rude, let me talk now. Yes.
Our conscience, a killer.
If it is that this woman got information, caller, that this man is of so much interest in her and him have affection for her and going to take her places. If it is that she believes that, based on what he told her to get man into her skin.
And tell her, oh, yes.
The man,
right.
The man
and
tell her no. Well,
he
on.
Knows. Let me finish that rule.
No, man.
He knows
the remittance,
that he normally comes down
the
and
green,
trick the girls
no,
them.
No.
Tell them stories.
No.
Just to get into their clothes.
No.
And here now he's saying, I know what happened that night, but
yeah,
she doesn't. If he knew the condom burst, said to her, say, baby, do one test because the condom burst.
Say, why the man a cut a man in?
He's a trickster. Then he is a trickster.
The man a cut a man in. What if he say? Him name of our number, no contact, no fear. 13 years ago, some big old phone is running the place.
Okay, no contact is there for her. Come on.
30 years, the man do this thing for.
Then the man is a pro at it. Hey,
30
what?
Years, the man do this rock, this nastiness for. 30 Terror. Years.
Terror.
Years.
Terror.
10 trips in.
Oh, yeah, look for the facts, boy. Yeah, the man is a dirty man. I mean, I take off him. He is a dirty
you're
man.
You're defending him.
But me, I say,
The other part to it is that the girl have some responsibility for bear upon this thing too. Because she, yo, listen, nobody can tell me say, I feel, she feels say, the college man or the pupa, and the college man tell him say, yo, dash with the belly. Because maybe the college man say, boy, I don't feel you that something go wrong.
Why are you going hypothetically now? Why is it okay to go hypothetic now on me?
But it's obvious. She said obvious the man left what? Her, and from the man left her head lick. You know, see it? It read straight. Read apart there.
Ter, if it is that this
read
man.
Read apart there.
If it is that this man was so interested in her.
Yes.
The fact that she. The fact that he left the island, she had no connection for this man.
Yo.
Right? Maybe he gave her a number and she had called and can't get through to him.
To be honest. Well, Anna, hear the part of the terror. To be honest, she didn't seem to really remember me that much.
But
during our conversation, she said she had dropped out of college because she had gotten pregnant some 13 years ago and her boyfriend left her when she decided not to do an abortion. And the whole thing took a toll on her. You know, I read something straight.
Okay. So her boyfriend.
No, you're putting.
She got pregnant.
When you read it.
Business, the boyfriend leave her. What going to happen? She must have a toll on her.
Because she feels her baby daddy left her.
But guess what? No. Not only that. Even she knew
her
she
school
had.
Love.
Even if she knew she had an affair, otherwise daddy rude, and the man got out in business.
No.
She can't get in touch with him.
She didn't have an affair.
Hey, daddy rude.
She didn't have an affair. It's a close pin thing, go on.
Hey, daddy rude.
Yeah.
You support the slackness. You know what darn well, so the people, them college girls picking it, probably they have nobody else with this worthless married man. It's a worthless married man. Because him ling, him can't use it up here for please the woman like she for please.
That's hypothetically speaking. Oh, you're the car card, sir.
You do it. So yeah. Go ahead, darling. Go ahead.
Go to Tara. Tara, you did it?
Twice a year, I'm going to trick people, girl, picking it. And your daddy, I support him, flatness. Him nasty.
Me not support where hold on.
I'm
not support him slackness.
You
know. When me I say no.
Supporting and I'm annoyed by it. Seriously annoyed.
Listen, when me I say, Zane, me wanna know right now where the man for because obviously him can't tell him woman afar and say him a run road down a yard. So me not go to road with Uno from early, me I tell you no. The man can't tell his wife afar in that. But him can go and pop by line friend yard. And make him friend ship it down in his friend name. That him have to do. And send down all kind of sitting for the daughter. Cause the daughter have got to private school now. And that thing for you know. Whole heap of things now have got to reach for them. But obviously, the man I seek forgiveness. I'm willing to forgive him if me did have a chance.
If he did nothing wrong, caller, why does he need forgiveness?
The man has said nothing wrong.
I'm asking you, Daddy Rude. If he had done nothing wrong and she was the clothespin, as you all put it, why does he need forgiveness?
The only reason why I said the woman a clothespin is because it obviously is a one-night stand and the green money catch her.
He can get forgiveness when he pull up him damn unlaced shoes and go handling business like a responsible man.
No, that's what I don't know, man.
Call him for radio, ask this thing. Should I just make him cry?
No. Remember last week?
Exactly.
Remember last week we talked about say boy a man get a youth a certain way too, you know. And the man I say, yo, John won't start Ray. That's how the thing go. Hey, listen. Straight up. Mm. When you look upon the old thing still, yeah. Seeing? Enough man fly down and run road.
Mm.
Right? Because a couple of my ex-girl them, a foreign man take them way. Some know a thing already. But at the same time, Tara. They're intimidating, you know. Me, I say, hey, you smell the pudding?
Yeah, I hear you. Go
pass,
on, yeah,
pass piece of pudding for me there. Right? Me, I look at it away where we have to try to see now how we can help that woman get as much as what she can get out of that man. That me, I pray. Because him owe it to her, big man thing.
Yeah, I'm a whole heap.
Yeah, but
13 years. Why should they have bad matter with the picking it by herself? But should she not finish college so she can have?
Yeah, but this.
Put them pa earth solid. Should they have slip on that slide?
Caller. Terry, you know the worst part of it?
Prosperous,
this man,
prosperous.
The worst part of it is he obviously knew that he had gotten her pregnant.
Yeah, go back over that, man.
He knew she was pregnant.
But you don't know if you find her.
Huh.
You know, the man,
oh,
the,
seriously, no.
The man caught. Is that probably is that?
He knew she was pregnant and left her for 13 years unattended.
Probably is that in a different parish. He might go buck her up too. Terror. Oh, we are gonna help that man because number one, as me say, in wife can't know what go on, right? And again, to the pitney for take care of, in daughter for take care of, and then now the mama for take care of. And oh, me look funny. Me think that girl a pass about 131. If you check it out, college, young college pitney, and unless you, if you're a college dropout, then that means she probably start when she's 18, right? So Carl said in a second year, she drop out. So she was probably about 19, 20 then time there. 13, so she maximum she about 33 years old. She a whole time. I don't know how to answer. As a matter of fact, she hit the jackpot.
That justifies it?
The man have legs.
What do you mean by hit she hit the jackpot? The woman could have had more out of life if she didn't have this crossive man for him see in her life.
What she could have, sir?
When she more youthful. Now she have to go work twice as hard to get a college degree. You know how hard it is for a woman go back to school in her them 30s.
Sorry.
Oh.
And then with Pitney.
No. Eh? The man will take care of all of that. All of that shit, he won't take care of. You see the word, etc. You see, etc.
You see, because he is.
Etc. mean everything, you know. And anything, you know.
You see, because my course is being such a jerk tonight, Mr. Itafala Fim Punto. I'm sorry. I deserve none.
It is good enough. Eh? Etc. Meaning, say, things.
Where's that, Maroon?
Etc. The man say, I want to take care of her. That's an open-ended statement. That could be anything. Right?
And then the man get back involved with her, too.
So well, nothing wrong with that.
Something wrong with it.
Why?
She must run the old croft.
Hold on. Terror. Support the man want to back with her and take care of her.
Something wrong with it, yes, Cleo. Him is all cruff.
Exactly. What? Run the boy. Yep.
Hold on.
Take what you take and run the boy. You don't deserve her.
Support the man decides him willing to kind of settle one little way with her.
I not give none of the pudding. None of the pudding I not give you.
So, no, hold on, make a reason or something. Because we not be emotional over this thing. We don't need so much emotions involved.
I'm not emotionalist. I know emotionalist. No, this is a thing true business, you know. I know no emotionalist. This not emotional. This man has been doing this for years.
Years.
And he's with it.
And him decides I'm going to stop, you know.
Him not stop.
Eh?
No,
he's
man.
Not stopping.
Remember, you know, the man said there was a connection. That means that him probably have like a feeling fear to, you know, something about her, you know. A destiny bring them back now, you know. Destiny. You don't believe in a destiny.
Here we go.
If you believe in a God, you must believe in a destiny, you know. So talk up from now, you know, if you are blaspheme. That one, the whole
Dara song. We're not getting anywhere with this dude.
Why not try to win me over for?
Let's see what the WhatsApp line is.
Terry, we're going to read the WhatsApp line here.
All right, darling. Thank you for calling back.
Yeah, go and read it. Come here, go and listen.
All right, sweetie.
All right, putos.
It's strange to me how she didn't remember what happened to her that night and him remember. Something not right there.
No, Grace, I go too far.
Because women always remember.
No, read them more, Grace.
Unless them intoxicated.
Grace, I go too far.
You sure? Thank you, Gracie.
Hello, good night.
Me I watch you with the pudding. Me not give none. I'm sorry.
Good night.
Hello, caller, you're on air.
Dan.
Oh, no. Listen.
Yes, Dan.
What do you mean?
Further upset me now, Dan. Further upset me.
Oh, you know, so the man knows the night that him get her pregnant.
Dan. Dan, please further upset me.
Him can't know that.
The man said he knows what happened that night, but she doesn't.
Yeah, he probably do something, but. He probably do something that and.
Don't, Dan, please. Dan, please.
The thing the man for doing.
In what they call it, paternity test, that's her name?
Dan, let me ask you a question. What do you think...
All right, Cleo,
What do you think he meant by that statement? In your wisdom and your knowledge as a man, what do you think he meant by that statement, Dandan?
All right.
Him answered already, you know.
No, he didn't. I didn't hear the answer.
All right, but simple thing. The man, if he feels I'm responsible for what going on, I'm just...
Dandan.
Your phone a break up, Dandan.
Dandan, darling.
Yeah.
Dandan.
Like all of it.
All right.
And while you're listening, Dandan, you still haven't answered my question, darling.
Of course he did.
He did not answer my question.
Yes, he did. But I never listen.
What do you think the man meant by the statement?
It's time we take a TV pudding. You wouldn't hear what I say.
You just call a while after I finish eating off the pudding. Hello, caller.
I Javi in this a call. And then, yes, Dandan, you're on the next line, too.
Yeah, me, I look at Empress that you have a call, you know why?
Yeah, you're a little better.
Much better.
Friend and I something similar. I should have tried to quash everything because... Trust me, Lady Cleo, you are so off.
Off?
Yeah. Because the thing is, majority of the girls, when they see the foreign and the bling and the rare, right? Now, this girl that was trying to call in, got pregnant by my uncle. You get me?
She did what?
He just come here like for 3 days.
Yes.
You hear me?
Yes.
Yeah, he just come here like for 3 days. Yeah? And she was like all over him. And then him do him thing and cut. And the guy what she was with, she get the baby and think and straight off him. Right? And right now I'm see my little cousin, me see my little sister right in half here. I'm going my uncle come and see what I go on and say, right? And killer dead, I know him, I should not even remember him.
Aye.
She not even remember him.
Yo, Javin.
Yeah.
Them a woman here, them a live in our fantasy world, the mills and bones where them a read. And when man a tell them something sitting, them a go on like they know things. Really? They don't know nothing. More than if a billion listen when we a talk. A real thing we a talk about.
Javine.
They go on as a woman perfect out there.
Javine.
Simple.
I am not saying that those cases do not happen. I am well aware that there are women out there. I am well aware that there are women out there who will jump on a man's bandwagon because him come from foreign and then bling, 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 and then love the bling. Yes, there are those women out there like that.
And not even forgot foreign.
I know, but I'm saying to you, based on what this man's is key, what is key for me in this whole story is that he knows what happened that night and she doesn't.
Maybe the condom burst.
If a condom burst, Javine, simply say to her, look.
He never know.
No. Hold on, man. The man say him know what happened. That means a million and one things possibly. So let us go with the condom burst.
The condom bust. That's
all. Condom burst and him know say him don't mean nothing by this encounter. It's only sex for him. Why not insist that, look, go do your testing because right now I'm involved with whoever.
My girl,
so we can't take another child right now.
About
so we can't take
no,
the child right
about
now.
So, whenever I'm.
So why I couldn't sex with she?
Exactly.
Why I couldn't do sex with she?
But that is why. No, I wonder if she can try call back.
Listen to what I'm saying to you. The statement, I know what happened that night and she doesn't, is suggesting a whole lot of things right there.
The man said obviously she don't know.
Because he knows that he was just having a one night stand. Maybe for her, she had something else in mind. That is how I'm interpreting that statement.
Javin. Hear the hypocrite in our clear say now. Me want one woman tell me say when them have sex with a man and the man ejaculate in a them, nothing not come out. He turn up there, they don't see nothing come out. No man an idiot in a this man. I want him to know.
Yes, he is.
I want to them, Davin. Tell them man for punk in a this.
Yes, he is. No matter
what. Where get the next call? Where get the next call here, me Dan?
Alright, bye.
Cool. I want to know clear. Oh, I'm Tono.
Let's take the caller, please.
Yeah, good night.
Yes, caller.
Hello?
Oh, I'm here again.
Yeah, me Dan.
You know what I said? Hey, you know, so realize, you know, when girls, when women are college, you know, that's at the time them experiment the most, you know.
Real talk.
Do not make a general statement, Dan.
See, what like to happen now with the man there? No. Women experiment in a college more than anything else. So it's like
not all women.
Not about the man.
Not all women.
But I like, you know. No. No, but that's when they experiment the most, in college. If they are experimenters, then do it at college. So it's like, oh, she don't remember nothing about the man. That means she must have done enough experimentation that in even register.
And if that's the case, she was the only one experimenting.
No,
you come here twice a year to experiment.
Eh?
If she was the only one experimenting, him not come here twice a year to experiment. Come on, Dan.
Dan, whenever I go down the road, where should I go?
I want you to answer my question since you called back.
Before I go, it's a come back to what I said a couple weeks ago, you know. When a man, 25% of the time, you know, a man, another person, child, you know.
Yeah.
Because the woman always pin the blame, quote unquote blame, on somebody else. Because them don't know what to pin it on.
And now hold themselves responsible.
And that's a problem that should be addressed even more.
So Dan, that what you just said is so true in many cases. But I'm asking you now this question. Since that is a fact in some instances, isn't it also a case where these men tell these women all kind of fabricated stories, and oftentimes too, and give them the impression that they are so interested in them and they have so much opportunity and promise for their future life and get them where they want them to go? You know what I'm saying too?
Well, all right. See, obviously, the man never...
Me ask a question, Dan.
Because she don't know nothing about him.
Dan, me ask you a question.
Wait, what question you ask me?
Me say, if aren't there cases where women who really want relationships are hoping to find a relationship with a man, but them a foreigner or not, and she thinks that it's going to go somewhere based on what he tells her, and then lo and behold, she discovers, it's a whole different kettle of fish this man up to. Gets pregnant and the man gone about in business, leave her. Aren't there cases, Dan, where these women are genuinely into the men and them gone about in business because him a shatter, him come here a year time, come spree, leisure and pleasure, and screw around the place and think it's okay because him a bag of chips. It happens, Dan.
Dan.
Yeah, no.
Dan.
Yes. Hold on, ma'am. Keep answering the question.
We're not denying that.
Dan. You know, but you deny it. You're saying the women are the ones who, in college,
Dan.
They experiment alone. And I'm saying to you, yes,
Dan.
Women in college experiment. But you have men, too, who come here because they feel, that and more.
And they come here
to treat the girls them.
I want him to tell Cleo.
And get them pregnant and left them.
Yeah. Dan, hold on. I want him to tell Cleo.
I want him to tell Cleo
and everybody else. A year's man I do that. They don't learn it. I want to them. Women, don't learn it.
That's the problem.
Don't learn it. Stop blaming
the
man.
That's the problem. You perpetuate the men's behaviors too much.
Women must realize what I get themselves into.
Since we are the problem, you know, Dan.
So it's okay to be a crook, Dan. It's Dan. Okay to be a crook.
No, but since we are the problem.
Man.
Since we are the problem, I don't know we are the problem. I don't learn it.
Me and my dad are college, you know. I'm being concerned about this thing, you know.
What you mean? Dan. Okay. I don't know what I learn.
So it's okay to be a crook. Ladies, you hear that?
I hear me.
Yeah.
They're defending being crooks. Okay.
We're not defending.
No, you're saying it's okay.
No,
but we must learn, but we must stop on what I do.
Well,
we must learn, but we must stop the nasty, dirty behavior and the killish behavior too. And we alone must stop it. It's a two-way responsibility, Dan. Men should be responsible, and the women should be responsible too.
Is a generation thing we're not trying to change.
And I'm saying it's clear. With the background, that I have a daughter who's in college right now. And what I'm saying is, this has been a long-standing problem where girls and women, they do most of the experimentation in college. And it's a fact. And this is something that we need, if we want to stem the problem, we need to address this issue. That's
our. And I'm not disputing that, and I'm just simply I'm simply adding that these old dogs out there must stop, come from far enough to them is all that and run around too. They must stop it too and push them sticking out everywhere where they find.
Dan. What women must realize, you see, all of my course, what women must realize is that, say, you see, when they say no, anything after no is rape. You hear me say?
Mm.
Anything after no is rape. So if you never say no, and a rape,
And your point?
It's simple. We are all, as men are always a prowl. And since, and since women analyze from long time, say, man a dog, keep telling we no, ease we off. Just say, yo, look, it not going to work out until you find that that person. Nobody go submit yourself. And then when you work out the way, oh, enough to work out, you're going to cuss we and say, we are this. And
so
we are
why
that.
Is it that when some women out there treat one giving that dose and one medicine, they can't deal with it?
Then what happened to we? We just mope and ball like we
that's
have
not what you do.
What would
you go kill these women and kill yourselves.
You know, you have got too far. Dan, the show almost up. Well, the show, we all pass
the
all time.
Up.
Later, hear me, Dan.
Yeah, man. Cool.
Respect.
And right. Dan come should on. Be a politician. He never answers my question.
Look, no, seriously, though. We out of time, but...
The show have to close it, but my head at right now.
But on a serious note, look. Ladies, you have to understand something. See? We had that show yeah, about 2 years or more than 2 years, whatever, I gonna. And at the same way as men, we get cussed for the same thing each time.
And you know, stop.
Hold on, why is it then?
No, why is it nothing? Well, stop. You don't stop.
I was on the floor.
You don't stop. You don't have no floor. Right? Then you cheer.
Why is it
stop.
That?
Don't ask the girls, why is it that? Why is it? What about asking all crofts out there? Be a man, no? Be a real, real man and stop
mistake.
Sending your sperm out of the
right?
place.
Why
he comes here twice
mistake?
A year, and I'm sure he goes around frivolously with all the girls he can get when he comes here every time for the year.
Yes.
And who to tell who him leave pregnant and go back a foreign?
Is it the problem?
The man link. The man them to man?
Well, I know the man link with and the man say, Ray. The man, in a way I'm right, the man say, yo, right now, as far as me say, me have to take care of the moms, yeah. And what the woman then spend time with, though? Cuss the man.
Be, oh, right? We're not justifying.
Cuss the man.
Guess what?
The man not ask somebody for justify nothing. The man say me not a spot. All the man want
as
know.
As far as yeah, I all right,
here we know. Let me advise you, me Dan. Straight up. No, listen to what none of them are say. Zane, listen to this.
Mm-hmm.
You have a youth, care for your youth. The woman get a setback in her life. Even if she never knows a fear picnic, she thinks at the next boy picnic, we want her to dash with the belly. And him left her, and he mash up her mess, right? It does happen. Saying, make sure she go back to school if she's willing to go back to school. You have to show her a way where you all look. You don't worry about certain things, just go mess the school. Whatever it is, particularly this 13-year-old child till she's whatever age, me go do that as our father. Saying, at that, me depend. You just do your part. You have to try to find out how you going to work out the finances so your wife and foreign don't know nothing about that. Right? But you have to prepare yourself too. So if and when she find out how you going to deal with it right there, sir.
May God help him.
Saying, just do yourself a favor. Just don't make sure you know, say, around you come a yard, come run road. Just make sure you know, say, sound like a sitting.
Oh, yeah,
sitting
mm-hmm.
Saying, simple as that.
Cover
so
up.
I just saw you go road boy. Everybody else are bunny out daddy road now, bunny out. You go and look at idiot thing. If you cut off of them, you're sitting when you're fed on a yard.
Oh,
and them there.
You
see?
Saying that now?
No.
Oh, a temperature's well, right there.
Somebody
Jesus.
Press replay. Rewind and replay.
First, you're saying that from night.
I said when Tara's on the phone. Oh. Say, boy, you're an idiot in the man, go on with.
Oh, please.
Of course, take a seat, me never said that.
We don't recall.
Yeah, no. Anyway, it's recorded. So, people. Thank you very much tonight.
Just to close, yes.
Oh, you want to say something?
Yes, man. Definitely, man.
Don't cuss
just
man.
To say, we talk about et cetera, help her out and et cetera. Mm. Help her where you can help her because she deserves the help. And help your picnic.
You
support your
house.
Child. But guess what? They said, et cetera,
house,
something there.
You forget her
left
house.
The woman alone now. You're married. Stick to your wife. And make the woman go find her life otherwise.
You forget
okay?
her house here, old boy.
She don't need your granana or banana or tealy. Anymore.
So we're going to cuss him.
No.
Leave
her alone.
About? We're that.
No, just leave we're the woman alone.
The man
mind
answer
your
that.
Picnic, etc. Mean anything.
The man, no, the man say want to take care of etc.
Etc. Mean a whole heap of things. Leave the woman alone and do your responsibility. And you men out there, you ladies
yeah, no.
out there
oh,
who are... I'm advising.
Or other people getting that.
Ladies
no.
out there who are allowing these men because they have the
yeah,
bling
no.
on them neck and the pocket them fat up, stop. Mm. Falling victims to them, please. And you men out there who are coming down and because you think you look so trash in our new suit or a new boot and you can't get a young girl who is so giddy and frivolous and frightened, please be responsible and stop dropping off on the sperm every and anyway because one day, it will catch up on you. Until next week, this is Lady Cleo on behalf of Cassidy and Daddy Rude saying,
got
calm
my
nerves.
for life.
Yeah. Next week, guys.
Dash up pay bills.